It is game two of this two-game series on the ice this weekend between Miami and Western Michigan. The Broncos in town for the series finale and the fourth meeting in 8 days between these two teams. It's the Broncos and the RedHawks on the ice tonight here in the NCHC. Alongside Luke West, Poley, Patrick Geshan with you here. Glad you're with us for game number two here on RedHawk Radio this afternoon on a Saturday. Weird 5 o'clock start, but everything has been weird about the last year or so. Luke, the Miami team last night that lost 4-1 after sweeping Western Michigan on the road last season. It's important that this team try to get something going in this Saturday before UMD comes in next weekend and the competition gets a lot tougher.
Absolutely. You know, the RedHawks have kind of been eased into the season a little bit, playing a Western Michigan team that on paper is a little bit more matched up with them. But as you mentioned, with, you know, a top 10 team in Minnesota Duluth coming in next week, the RedHawks really got a big game here. Last chance for a tune-up here for the Bulldogs' visit next weekend.
Let's talk about a Western Michigan team that came out of the pod with only two wins and an opportunity for them tonight to take a road sweep into their series next week against St. Cloud State back at home. Andy Murray's team has done a really consistent job of locking up Miami in the defensive zone when they've been successful against them this season. What do you expect tonight for the Broncos?
I expect more of the same. I think Andy Murray's team has really come out well out of the pod. It was a different team than we're used to seeing Western Michigan play inside the pod. They gave up 10 goals against Omaha. You know, they're averaging giving up 4 or 5 goals a game while they're inside the pod. I think it's a different team now that they're outside. They're playing more sound defensively, and I think that's just going to continue tonight.
Ludwig Pearson gets a start in net, Luke, for the RedHawks tonight. Number 32 in white out of Hinde, Sweden. Kind of surprising for a lot of people thinking that, well, why would you start him again after the performance last night? But he is one of the top rookie goaltenders in the nation this year and just continues to be the bright spot for the RedHawks no matter what has been going wrong for them so far this year.
Yeah, this guy's been unreal. He played really well, as I talked to you before the broadcast, last year in the North American League with the Lone Star Brahmas, and he hasn't missed a beat here as he stepped into college. Really been a huge bright spot for the RedHawks. He's been able to save them when they haven't been playing as well, and the RedHawks have really been able to reap the rewards of number 32 in white on the offensive side as well.
On the other side, Alex Aslanidis, we imagine we get the start for Western Michigan again. He will, in fact, do that. So we will get our starting lineups, the national anthem from our public address announcer, Scott Triver, ahead of puck drop right now.
Between the Western Michigan Broncos and your Miami RedHawks. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are the starting lineups for tonight's game. First to introduce the visiting Broncos of Western Michigan. And starting in goal for the Broncos, wearing number 35, Alex Aslanidis. Starting at left defense, number 24, Aiden Folt. Starting at right defense, number 7, Ronnie Atter. At left wing, number 21, Josh Castle. Starting at center, wearing number 16, Tim Washi. And at right wing, number 14, Jason Poland. And the rest of the Broncos. Western Michigan is coached by assistant coach J.J. Crew and associate head coach Pat Furschweiler. The head coach of the Broncos is Andy Murray. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for your Miami RedHawks. And starting today in goal, the freshman from Hinda, Sweden, number 32, Ludwig Pearson. Starting at left defense, a junior hailing from Troy, Michigan, it's number 13, Derek Dashke. At right defense, a sophomore out of Detroit, Michigan, number 5, Jack Clement. Starting in left wing, the freshman from Williamsville, New York, wearing number 29, Matthew Barbolini. Your center is the senior out of Gaylord, Michigan. It's number 39, Casey Gillig. And starting at right wing, a senior from Phoenix, Arizona, number 67, Phil Nyes. And the rest of your Miami RedHawks. Director of Hockey Operations, Jimmy Spratt. The RedHawks are coached by Associate Head Coaches Eric Rude and Barry Schutte. And in his second season at the helm of Miami Ice Hockey, Head Coach Chris Bergeron. The officials are assigned for this evening's game by the National Collegiate Hockey Conference. The referees tonight are Stephen Renault and Joe Sullivan. Our linesmen are Troy Merritt and Eric Frank. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we invite you to rise, remove your hats, and join us as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Starting lineups and national anthem for our game this afternoon. Western Michigan will start Alex Aslanidis in their net again, number 35, the freshman out of Morristown, New Jersey. Four games, got his first one of his career last night in the 4-1 decision over Miami, 1-0-0 on the year, 3.63 goals against, 8.33 save percentage. RedHawks go again with Ludvig Pearson out of Hinde, Sweden, the 6-1, 184 freshman. 4-3-1 record, 1.37 goals against, 9.57 save percentage for Ludvig Pearson. Our referees tonight are Joe Sullivan and Stephen Renault. Eric Frank and Troy Merritt will work the lines. RedHawks move left to right across your radio here in period number one. Their alternate home uniforms, Miami across the front in red. It's a white uniform. The Miami is in script. It's like a baseball pinstripe pattern. On the back are the red names across the top of the back with the red numbers. Western Michigan, same as last night, their standard road black uniforms. Western Michigan in tan across the front, tan number on the back, and the white name across the top of the back as well. Luke, what are some things you're looking for here at the start?
Well, I think from the RedHawks perspective, it needs to be a fast start, obviously, but I think they need to protect their defensive zone well. You don't want to give up any goals early, especially coming off a loss. Really need to establish the momentum right away, and that starts with sound defensive hockey.
So the Miami forward line of Matthew Barbellini, Casey Gilling, and Phil Nyes will get things started here for the RedHawks at center. It's a face-off win, and we're underway in game two of this series. D&D, they go in the defensive zone. Jack Clement, the play through the middle, tipped into the circle by Casey Gilling on net. As Landis puts it behind his cage, Aiden Fulp out there for Western Michigan for a quick breakout. But the possession changes at center. Gilling trying to feed it left wing. The puck taken over by Jason Poland. Phil Nyes will work it right wing at center to dump it opposite corner to the far side of the Western Michigan zone. Ronnie Adder, the only draft pick on the Broncos squad, dumps it in right wing at center. He's out of the Philadelphia Flyers in a 2019 draft. Puck goes behind the net of Pearson. Derek Askey, far corner Miami zone, will hit the brakes and take it back behind the net where Warwick Russell gets a pass in the near corner. His feet up the right wing. Went off the stick of Hilson Dagger to the stick of Joey Cassetti coming through the middle. He turned it over to Cole Gallant at the Bronco line. And he's over the Miami line now, but lost the puck, kind of come through the circle as Russell kind of tampered with him. Back at the line, Scooter Bricky trying to fire a shot. Went into the legs of Cassetti, back to the Western zone, who then dumps it into the Miami end. And Robbie Drazer on the right side of defense will get a tip by Cassetti through center. Never mind, never tipped. On the stretch pass attempt, an early icing call against Miami. 1 minute and 9 seconds into our first period. Patrick Geshan, Luke Westpulley with you here. Rest of our great Red Hawk radio crew on hand in Oxford, Ohio tonight. Glad you're with us on Red Hawk Radio in game two of this series between Miami and Western Michigan. Broncos trying to come away with a sweep after their 4-1 win in the game last night. A contest where they outshot Miami 37-17. It was not pretty if you were cheering for the RedHawks last night. Josh Pastrzak near circle the offensive zone for the Broncos. The play knocked to the far side where Cassetti cannot clear. Coming in there for Western Michigan was Cole Gallant. He sent it to the near circle. Fiedler came in from the point trying to play it deep and will, but Miami the only ones back below the goal line to grab it. Matt Berry coming through the far circle of his own end. Robbie Drasner back to neutral ice. Western grabs it there. Paul Washi will play it right back to the far corner of the Miami zone. Russell, D&D behind the net for Drasner. Up ahead for Ryan Savage through the middle. Play broken up at the near wing. Pasilt turned it over to Loun, and now they battle for it right in front of the Western Michigan bench in front of us in neutral ice. Pasilt comes away with it. The play to the middle. Ethan Rome over the line on the right wing. Beg your pardon, Jamie Rome out of Calgary, Alberta. He'll play this one to the middle. Slap shot indirect off the far boards by Glover. Turned aside. We got a penalty coming up here on the Redhawks. His capstick completely leveled Ty Glover in the near half wall in the Miami zone. It was away from the puck. Pearson will touch it behind his net after a Western Michigan dump in. And the first power play of the game goes to the Broncos with 17:42 remaining in period number one. Ty Glover, the victim of the penalty, Alec Capstick will go here, but for what? 2 minutes for cross-checking.
Yeah, it's a tough penalty for Alec Capstick to take so early. Initiated contact back when the puck area still had the puck, but couldn't finish that one off after it's cleared away, and he gets two to think about it, and now we'll see the first of this game for the Western Michigan power play.
Western Michigan power play that was 0-for-3 last night, 22.5% on the season. They win the draw to the far circle of the Miami zone. Joy Hall in the middle of the ice with a drive there, came off the end boards. Glover with it behind the Western Michigan net. Feeds it to the far wing where it was grabbed by Drew Worad to the near wing for Frank in the circle. Big shot there, padded on the right side of Pearson. The rebound to the stick of Phil Nyes, and he clears all the way down the ice. As Landis behind his cage, hands it off. Here's Joy Hall scanning it out of the Western Michigan zone. Glover over the line of the left wing. Gave it back for Gallant, and they're on the right side of the zone. Here's Worad, far circle by MEN. Playing it back for Joy Hall. Behind the net, Glover sends it back around the board to the right point for Joy Hall, who waits for it and skates it to the middle of the blue line. Passed up the far circle. Worad to the slot. Gallant back for Worad. Little backhand shot. Right into the breadbasket of Pearson, who makes the stop with 1:10 to go in the power play. 16:51 remains in the first. So you had good offensive puck movement there from Western Michigan on the power play, and the draw to the left of Pearson. That features Paul Washi and Joe Cassetti, who had two goals in a Sunday game last week at Western Michigan. Adder, left point after a Western faceoff win. Center line, Fulp to Adder, a drive from the top of the near circle that goes off of Pearson and out of play. With 1:01 to go in the power play, 16:42 remains in the first. So the draw back to the right of Pearson. Again, a crowd of just family and friends today here at Goggin, not open to the public. About 75 to 100 people maybe in the stands. You could say 150 if I'm guessing. Fulp, right point, Western Michigan controls on offense. Far circle, Pasilt, the play broken up, but back to the line for Fulp. Top of the near circle, Adderd. Fulp, right wing, lets it go to the boards. Takes it back to the point, now center line. Feeds a far circle, Pasilt. We'll get this one to the left point, Adderd on it. Skates it middle, back to the near circle, Poland. Center line, Fulp is shot, big save by Pearson, rebound. Comes to the corner where it's grabbed by Adderd. Little wrister there, and Adderd forced out of the zone by Dashke with 20 to go in the power play. Phil Nyes sends it down the left wing into the Western Michigan zone where it is grabbed by Fulp. Feeds it over the line right wing. Pasilt to the middle. Granger came off the bench. She's at the right point. We'll circle around there. Power play about to expire here against Western Michigan as Capstick will exit the box now. Pasilt far half wall. We'll skin it up to the right point. Down to the corner for Granger. Turn over there to Clement as we're back to 5-on-5 and they're out of the zone. Jack Clement gets to the left wing at center. The dump into the far corner. As Landis will let it go behind his net. Scooter Bricky leaves it there for Hilsendanger. The wrap around the far boards. Granger and Rydquist tie up for it there. Pletsy comes in and win the battle for Miami. Ben Loun, center line. Mahulik in the lineup tonight. He was not last night. Top of the near circle, a shot wide of the net. Western Michigan clears it back to center. Loud to the near wing, Gilling back across the red line. Loud copped it up there. Granger going down the right wing will hit the brakes, top of the far circle, and play it behind the net for Hugh Larkin. Larkin ties up to the corner with Mahalik and Gilling. Sent up to the near wing. Hilson Dagger collides with Pletsky. Puck in the circle. It's Rome, the centering feed in front. Tim Washi trying to go over to Joy. Oh, they couldn't connect though on the right wing. And it's back in the far corner of the Miami zone. Gilling rides Tim Washi up the far half wall. Ben Lowne, the chip back to center. Joy all played it ahead as Casey Gilling on it. He'll send it back to the Miami zone, and Hampus Reichquist will get back to retrieve it behind the Miami net. Pass far circle. Here's Gilling. We'll skate it out, feed it right wing. Mahalik will chip it over the Bronco line behind the net as Landis sends it right back around the near boards. Glover sends it to the middle of the ice. Ethan Rome picks it up center circle over the Miami line left wing, but he will throw it out of play. Trying to dump it in off the high glass. 14-13 remains in the first period. Broncos out shooting Miami 4-0. No score. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. T13 remains in the first period. No score between Miami and Western Michigan on the ice as they clean up the ice between the media timeouts. Get the shoveling crew off. Drive to the neutral ice. Right wing of the Miami blue line. Closest to there. And Western Michigan, the quick win back. Get it to the near corner of the Miami end. Ethan Frank behind the net. Grabs it there for the Broncos. Gains it to the far side. It's a break far circle. Trying to slide a shot through a few sticks. It went out of play after a deflection as Drazner was there, and so was Cassetti close to the net to get a piece of it. 13:59 to go in the first. No score, Miami and Western Michigan. Patrick Geshan, Luke West pulling with you here. Glad you're with us. Game two of the series on Red Hawk Radio. Miami trying to grab home win number one of the season. Western Michigan, clean win in the offensive zone. Ethan Frank will slide it off the end boards on a shot wide. It came back in front for a chance at the left post. Warad was there, but Pearson shut him down with a pad. Addard in his own end for Western Michigan. The play up the right wing, tipped into the Miami zone near corner to wave off the icing. Savage first to it. Up the near wing boards for Ben Lowne. Back to center. Pletsky let it go on the stick of Addard, who sends it indirectly to Tarakaski's stick, rather, trying to clear it out of his zone end, and Western Michigan got a hold of the puck but entered the zone offside with 13.5 to go in the first.
I think it's important here for the Redhawks to regroup a little bit. They've been back on their heels ever since that penalty kill even started, and now even since the penalty kill has ended back 5-on-5, so now the Redhawks need to regroup a little bit and try and get an offensive shift.
And the play has been in the Bronco end for the Bronco offensive zone for the majority of this period, nearing the halfway point of it. Kapsik can't clear up the far boards from his own zone. Western Michigan applying the offensive pressure here. Granger up the far side. Sends it to Bricky. Left wing Hilson Dagger at the point. Behind the net. Graham stick checks it to the corner. Hampus Reichquist is there to play it back behind the net to Kapsik. The pass there couldn't connect. And Granger will take over. Poor defensive zone puck handling by Miami. Granger gave it up. Caleb Rule to Silver. The play up ahead through the middle. And Graham was the intended recipient of that pass, but it went 2 feet left of him. Up behind the Bronco net, they'll work it out to center. Pass Salt couldn't get the pass off the stick of Granger. Drazner slides a far circle. Rourke Russell, the tip ahead at the left wing by Brian Silver behind the Bronco net. Joyall will take this one behind the cage. Michael Joyall out of Bloomingdale, Illinois, up the left wing. Hillenbrand with a shot top of the near circle after a Bronco offensive zone entry. And a glove save made by Pearson. And with 12:27 to go in the opening period here from Oxford, Western Michigan, Luke, out shooting Miami 6-0, to your point.
Yeah, it's really been all Western thus far, and Miami's got to get something going here 5-on-5. They want to get any type of momentum going in the second half of this period.
Russell to the far half wall, Barbellini, as Miami tries to clear after a defensive zone draw win. Russell behind the net, played it out. Barbellini will stick it to center. Right wing, Joyo has it for the Broncos. Back behind. And Western Michigan clears it up the near side of the ice, trying to hit a pass. I think Fiedler was back there in his own end. Looking to the left wing for Hillenbrand, who never touched it. They're going to bring Hillenbrand back out on the ice. On the ice, they call it to Broncos. So offensive zone chance here for the RedHawks with a draw coming to the left of Aslanidis. Again, Miami still without a shot, almost 8 minutes in.
Yeah, no, and I think the most important thing for the RedHawks here is just to press, keep this puck in the Bronco end as long as possible, especially with tired guys on the ice.
Puck to the corner behind the net. Cassetti trying to slide it in on the left post there on Aslanidis, who made the cover. After a nice face-off win, they got it to the corner, and Cassetti working down there with Barry, able to put it on net, and the RedHawks there with their first shot of the game, 11:59 left in the first.
Yeah, just a mixed direction from Cassetti behind the net. He kind of faked the wraparound and tried to go back where it came from and jam that, but Aslanidis was all over that one.
Western wins the draw near side of their defensive zone. Rome can't clear it. It went off Sladek and back in on net. It bounced in on Aslanidis. Rome standing far half wall. Sladek applying the pressure and unable to clear was Western Michigan. Broncos brought about 15 fans or so, parents and friends who are in attendance today in their section. All spaced out. Draw the far circle to the right of Aslanidis. Western will not be able to work it out initially. They do on a second try. It's Van Oss over the Miami line right away as Warad with him on the rush. The backhand shot a little off the ice, and Pearson makes the glove save next to his left post with 11:37 to go in the first, and a nice rush the other way by the Broncos.
Yeah, just a quick move up the ice and put it on net and see if anything can happen, but Pearson's just going to gobble that one up and freeze it for a draw.
So it's Monty Graham in this faceoff. He'll square off with Warad. Puck in the far corner and sent behind the net by Western Michigan. Cole Gallant will take a tour of his attacking zone. Back for Radford, center point. His wrister goes over the net after it deflected off his stick. Picked up by Fulp. Near half wall, gave it away to Caleb Rule. He and Fulp will tussle as they go through neutral ice. Rule knocked to the ice. Loose puck, though, picked up by Cassetti over the Bronco line left wing, but lost it to the corner. And behind the net, Addard will cycle it to the far wing for Fulp, but he lost it. Rule, the chip back to the far corner of the Western Michigan zone. Addard is there, but had trouble. Now Miami in a battle for it as Rule will spin away from this puck and get a shot off from the far circle as Aslanidis the glove save with 10:58 to go in the first. There's some offensive zone pressure by Miami, a strong forecheck and good work by Caleb Rule and Joe Cassetti.
Yeah, this all starts in their defensive zone. They're able to force a turnover and get it going the other way with Caleb Rule. Force another turnover there, they get an offensive chance, and now they got a draw on the offensive zone.
Takes place to the right of Aslanidis. And right in on that is Casey Gilling, was taking it for Miami against Tim Washi. He just tried to win it forward, and it went in on Aslanidis. So Gilling here against Tim Washi. Gilling wins it back top of the far circle. Nice to the line for Russell. Plays it back behind the net to the far corner. Barbellini up the half wall. Cycles it down low. Nice behind the net. Works with Bricky. Clean win Western Michigan on the battle. Pulling back to center. Grabbed by Hillenbrand and back down the ice to the far corner behind the cage. Nilsson dagger on it there. Tied up with Drazner. They lose the battle. Hillenbrand on it for the Broncos till Gilling ties him up in Miami. Back the other way along the near wing. Although Gilling's exit pass picked off by Poley left point. And the Broncos set up on offense. Poley to the line. Hilson Dagger's drive. Nice right pad save by Pearson. Tim Washi to the corner. Hilson Dagger left point. Slides it right side. Bricky, his shot blocked by Barbellini, who's a happy man today and we'll tell you about that later. Nielsen dagger to the right point, back down to the far half wall. Passolt with Gilling. They tie up in a one-on-one battle. Passolt, the stronger player, come away with it and back to center. He'll take it through the center ice circle. All by himself, over the line of the left wing. Ripped a wrister off the right post. Rebound sent to the near half wall. Cassetti back to center. Fiedler on Western Michigan has it. Slides it D&D to the right wing at center, where it's dumped in by Joyall. Russell near corner of his own end. Back through the middle. Drazner grabs it in the Western Michigan offensive slot. Back in the Miami zone near corner. Gilling will send this one cross ice down to the Western Michigan end. Joyo there playing it through the middle right to the stick of Dashke standing in his own slot, and the Miami will take it behind their net and around the boards to the right wing for Drazner. Stretches it left wing at center. Sladek to dump into the far corner. The Bronco end asks Lanny this. Sends it around the near wing boards. Back to the right point, Clement. The shot tipped wide of the net. Barry behind the cage grabs it for Miami. In front of the right post as Sladek sent it back to the corner. Barry right point was poke checked away, skating the puck by Adder back to center. Dashke with it, slides it up the left wing boards, past Adder and Pletsky, and this will go all the way down the ice behind the Western Michigan net, but the icing waved off on the tip. Van Oss to the middle, Aiden Fulk right wing at center. Hugh Larkin will try to kick this one free from Dashke. They tie up, back to the Western zone. Adder slides it left wing as Barry chips it past Ty Glover. Ian Savage collide, near circle it's Clement. Fires it off the boards, right wing at center, back into the Western Michigan zone as Fulp near corner will chase it for the Broncos, who lead the shots 9-2 with 8:20 to go in the first. Back to center, Caleb Rule breaks up the play on Van Oss. Ben Lowne in his own end, feeds it right wing at the Miami line, right quist cross ice over the Bronco line left wing. Caleb Rule lost the puck to the corner after a hit by Fulp. Behind the cage, Ben Lowne in the corner with it. Back to the right point, Rehnquist slides it left point. It could not reach Kapstick, chipping it past him. Gallant, breakaway the other way, and he'll shoot it on the right circle. It went wide of the net. Nice play by Rehnquist to get back defensively and tie his stick up. And the puck on a clearing attempt into the Miami bench with 7:51 to go in the first. All Western Michigan so far on offense early in this one. They're out shooting Miami 9-2. In a scoreless affair from Oxford, this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. To go in period number one here from Oxford. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley with you here. In game two of this series between Miami and Western Michigan. No score. Draw coming up neutral ice in the Miami right wing closest to their blue line. Casey Gilling in it with Drew Warad, and it's a clean win by the RedHawks. Mark Russell in his own end. Robbie Drazner plays it through the middle. The tip by Casey Gilling at the Bronco line to the far corner. Ethan Frank near half wall, the chip back to center. Gallant leaves it there, and Russell slides it left wing where it's tipped in over the Bronco line by Nyes. Far corner, Barbolini gives up for Nyes. Back to the left point. Russell slides it right wing for Drazner. The shot from the line that tipped off the crossbar and over the net. Nyes to the far side for Frank. The wrap around the boards to the near wing. Cole Gallant on it will slide it to the middle. Drew Warad chipped it off his stick to Drazner, and Russell and Drazner go D&D. In their own end a few times. Russell comes away with the puck, left wing, slides it through center where it's off the stick of Phil Nyes to the near corner. Barry, the wrap around the boards to the far half wall. Jason Poland will grab it there and tie it up against the half boards with Dashke and Cassetti battling for Miami against Nielsen, Dagger, and Poland. Tim Washi joins the party for the Broncos. Cassetti away with the puck, leaves it to the corner. Joyall grabs it there but gave it up for Barry. Nielsen, Dagger wraps it around the boards on the near wing. Clement at the right point. will lose it and pull it back through center. Gave it up on the right side. Over the line comes Joyal. Floats it past through the middle. Poland there could not grab it with his stick. The puck sent back to center ice where Fiedler has it left wing at center. Slides it over on the right wing. Tim Washi the dump into the zone. Right pad save as it came on net by Pearson. Here's Ben Lown over the line of the left wing. Will chip it over the stick at Cassetti behind the net. Fiedler and Savage crash in for it to the near corner. Ben Lown. Up the boards, we'll send this one to the far side. Dashke, the wrap around the boards to the near half wall where Ben Lown will send it down low. Savage, the intended recipient of the pass. Fiedler tripped him up. Penalty coming up from that. Savage behind the net. We'll scan it up the far half wall to the corner. He's tripped up again by Fiedler. We have two arms up, maybe a double minor coming here, as Savage was tripped twice. So what do we have, Luke Westpoley? Well, one referee says interference. I think maybe they just had the same thing. The referees will not talk. So they call interference when Savage was upended. Is that the right call?
I'm not sure that they called the same thing. I don't know.
I don't think they did either.
Yeah, that's interesting. I think maybe both officials thought they called, because the official in the near corner did not go call. He put his arm up initially, did not go to call the penalty. That looked like a trip, and he had his arm up for it, so we thought we were going to get a tripping call, and then Savage was tripped up again later as Western Michigan gets a clear here. And we saw the official outside the zone put his arm up, and that was the penalty that was called. It was called for interference. So interesting sequence here, but the Redhawks end up with a two-minute power play.
Perry over the Bronco line, left wing after an initial clear. Cassetti to the near wing for Gilling, trying to play it through the middle. Barry there for a tip, but it went behind him. They chase after it far half wall. Barry to the middle, Gilling near circle, and a point blank chance, but sent it over the net, top left. Dashke center line, Gilling to the far circle. Barry waits, Dashke center point. The drive, pad save as Landinus, and the rebound picked up by Warad. The backhand pitching wedge down the ice on Pearson. Quickly sending a stretch pass up the left wing boards. Barry had it over the Bronco line left wing. Bricky stripped him of the puck and an immediate clear back down the ice for the Broncos with 1:08 to go on the power play. Miami with it in their own end. Barry in the far corner picks up the puck, slides it near wing for Rehnquist. We'll take it to the safety behind the Miami net. You got one forechecker in the zone, that's Paul Washi. Rehnquist emerges from behind the cage up the right wing. Over center, will chip it over the Bronco line to the corner as Landon is a risky play to go into the corner on a Miami forecheck to send it to the near wing. He's fine, gets back in the net as they battle for it in the near circle, and a clean Western Michigan clear is sent down by Paul Watchy. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Miami power play, that's just 14.6% on the season. They were scoreless in that department last night, 0-3. Nice, finds Barbolini over the Bronco line on the right wing. The slide around the boards to the near corner. Nice picks it up there, trying to battle with Fulp. He's shoved down, and Fulp emerges away with a puck. Sends a left wing pass for Gallant, who's got one man to beat in Rehnquist, but a nice stick check by Rehnquist to send it to the near half wall. Monty Graham over the line on the right wing, down the half wall. Drop pass for Nice, top of the near circle. A shot blocked off the skate of Bricky as we're back to 5-on-5. So not much of a power play chance there for the Redhawks with 3:36 to go in the first. Up behind the Bronco net. Fulp ties up Phil Nyes behind the cage. Far corner, Fiedler comes away with it. Pass up. Up the far boards, over center. We'll feed it left wing. Rome off the bench to the near circle. Nice stick check there by Kapstick before Rome had a point blank chance. Rome with it near corner. Slides it to the middle. Off the skate of Joyo, who had a point blank opportunity. Back to center it goes. Nilsson Dagger feeds it right wing, and Joyo the wrap around the board to the near half wall. Out of the reach of Mahalik, Sladek over center, then over the Bronco line slowly as he was tied up with Van Oss. Glover with the puck center of the ice as the Broncos steal it away. He chips it over the Redhawk line right wing and behind the Miami net. Mahalik crashes down there with Rome. Lound to the far half wall for Kapstick. Played it up ahead to the middle of the ice. Joyo there in the center circle. Back in his own end, will circle away. And in front of the net, Hilson Dagger to the middle. Out of the reach of Van Oss. Russell, the play to the left wing, chipped into the far corner of the Bronco zone by Lown, who is standing at the Bronco line. Savage and Hilson Dagger tie up for the puck down there with 2.5 to go in the first. No score between Miami and Western Michigan. Canucks win the battle. Barry up the far boards. Couldn't get it past Scooter Bricky. Trying to go up to the line for a pass. Back to center. RedHawks quickly over the line again. Savage coming through the middle of the ice. Lost the puck as it was bouncing in on Aslanidis, who makes the cover with 2:13 to go in the first. No score, Miami and Western Michigan. This is Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio. Team remains at period number one by Midwestern Michigan. Our scoreless on the ice. Patrick Enchin, Luke West Poley with you here on RedHawk Radio. Drawing the Miami offense's own far circle. Derek Dasty down the half wall for Barbolini. The play behind the net finds Casey Gilling in the corner. He's up the far half wall with a puck for the RedHawks, but lost it to two Broncos standing there as Granger then loses it to Gilling. And now Tim Washi over center chips it over the Miami line to the far corner. Clement first to it for the RedHawks. Hilson Dagger near corner. Chips it up the wall. Turn over to Gilling. Back to center for Barbolini. Attard chipped it off the near wing boards. Phil Nye sends it back behind the net as Fulp grabs it far corner for Western Michigan. Play up the right wing boards. It is sent in cross-corner dumped in by Bricky. Attard will grab it away from Sladek. Now in the middle, you have Ethan Frank. Far circle, wide open. Look for Western Michigan. Rips a shot wide right of the net. Nilsson Dagger left point, wraps it from the line all the way down around the boards to the far wing. Bricky back to the right point for Gallant. The shot through the circle. Warad there to block his own man's attempt to get it on net. And Miami clears it to center. Barry over the Bronco line left wing and Sladek with him. And they are offside. That will kill you with 1:05 to go in the first. No score, Miami and Western Michigan.
Yeah, that's how you make your teammates give you an... Little bit of words of advice on the bench when you get back there. Nothing is going to grind your teammates or line mates' gears more than jumping off sides on a rush.
So the RedHawks win the neutralized draw on their left wing, closest to the Bronco line. They rip it around the boards to the far half wall of the Western zone. Clearing attempt blocked down by Capstick left point, but Poulin sends it right wing and Attard. The pass to Paul Washi of the Miami line with less than a minute to go in the period. Washi shot top of the far circle. Blocked to the corner. Washi with it again behind the net. Capstick chips it forward. Poulin up the left point for Western Michigan. Lost it to Savage. Pletsky the chip over the line on the right wing for Miami. Back for Fulp in the corner. And left it there for Paul Washi. Up the boards. Controlled by Attard through the middle. They'll take it over the middle of the Miami line with 22 seconds left in the period. Gilling will play it back to center. Barbolini for Nice, who's hit there by Poland pretty hard. An interference as they were coming into the Miami zone is the call. And Western Michigan will go shorthanded on the Jason Poland minor. RedHawks back to their second power play of the game.
It's a good play by Nice to just slide himself in that spot along the boards, and Poland lays a hit on him before he makes a play on the puck, and that's a killer for Western Michigan to take a penalty with such little time left in the period. And now the RedHawks with a bit of a chance here to end the first.
Trot to the right of Aslanidis, 10 seconds to go in the first. It goes behind the Bronco net. Frank in the near corner, locks up against the boards with Savage. You have Cassetti down there too in this battle as they just try to wind the time down in the period. And that's a successful mission in the corner. There's a nice, smart play there by Frank to just lock it up against the boards, run out the last 10 seconds of the period to give us a scoreless end of 20 minutes here in Oxford. 1:45 remains in the power play for Miami, so that's what will carry over into the second, and your shots are in favor of the Broncos, 8-4. Your thoughts, Luke, after 20?
Well, I think it was a really slow start for the RedHawks. I think that Western Michigan really jumped on them to start the game, and lucky to not give up a goal there. I thought their play got better as the period went on. Still need a little bit more pressure, though. The RedHawks, on a couple of shifts, you could really notice the high pressure on the puck carriers and their forechecking. They're forcing some turnovers. That's how they were able to get most of their offensive opportunities in the zone. For the Western Michigan Broncos, I think they just got to get back to how they were in the beginning part of that period. I thought they were really good. They really hopped on the RedHawks well. Weren't able to come out with a goal, and they kind of relaxed off on the last 15 minutes, and it was more of an even period, but still great first 5 minutes for Western Michigan, and if they get back to that, they should be in very, very good shape in the next 40.
I agree with you on that. So 8-4 are the shots in favor of the Broncos after 20. Miami is 0-1 on the power play. Western Michigan 0-1 on the power play as well in that period. RedHawks losing the faceoff battle 12-8. The Broncos, the better teams in faceoffs this afternoon. RedHawks have 3 blocked shots to Western's 1. And in terms of penalty minutes, Western Michigan with 4, Miami with 2. So no goals to talk about either in that first period. In terms of our scoring summary, just one other game going on in the league tonight. It's a 7 o'clock start between St. Cloud State and Minnesota Duluth, and a very exciting one. Last night they played in Duluth where St. Cloud got the 4-3 win, scoring in the last few minutes of that one. So the Huskies and Bulldogs battle tonight at Amsoil Arena for a 7 o'clock Central Time start in Duluth. Those are the two opponents that these two teams will battle next weekend. Western Michigan will be home against St. Cloud next week, and Miami will be home against Duluth. So that will do it for our first period. Our second period coming up here in about 13 minutes or so between Miami and Western Michigan. The Redhawks will be on the power play to start off the period, and we'll take just a little bit of a break here and be back with the second in about 12 minutes or so. No score, Miami and Western Michigan. First intermission, this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Test. No score between Miami and Western Michigan. About to get our second period underway here from Oxford, Ohio. 20 minutes will go up on the clock, and Miami again will start this period on the power play. 1 minute and 45 seconds left in it after a Jason Poley cross-checking minor at the end of that first period. Patrick Etcher, Luke West, Poley back with you here. Redhawks move right to left across your radio in this period. Luke, what are you looking for at the start of the second 20?
Well, I think for the Redhawks, you got to hope for a better start of the second 20 than you had in the first 20. Did some offensive shifts early for the Redhawks. They really needed time to settle in, and that time that they took, you know, allowed Western Michigan to get about 7 or 8 shots and really establish themselves in the offensive zone. But now starting the period on the power play, they got a great chance to get some offensive momentum going.
They win the center ice draw to get the period going. Derek Daskey will take it behind his net as Miami will get going here on the power play. Casey Gilling, the play back. Here's Barry through center ice over the line on the right wing. Cross ice feed to the left point for Cassetti. Near circle for Matt Barry. But he lost it right at the rim of the circle to Pat Silt, and will cut this one down back behind the ice. Next to Pearson. Gilling there, hands it back for Daskey. Sends it up to near wing. Barry chipped it forward. Cassetti back for Daskey. Right wing for Gilling. In the middle, Barry tripped up, and Frank, an easy backhand to the Miami zone. Gilling first to it. Gave it over for Daskey. Right wing at center. Dumps it in around the boards to the far side of the Western Michigan zone. Barry right point greets it there to the far circle for Savage. Back to the line for Barry. Left point Daskey with a putt. The shot in, deflected off Frank. And back down the ice after it went off the stick of Warad. Barry in his own end, feeds it left wing. Cassetti over the line. Let it go as Gallant will send this one back down the ice and behind the net. Pearson will grab it with 30 seconds to go in this anemic power play, Luke.
Yeah, high zone turnover is really just killing the Redhawks right now. As soon as they take the zone, it seems like the puck just bounces off a stick and Western Michigan gets it clear.
Puck behind the net, and Ronnie Adderd on it for the Broncos. Gets it back to the left point. Russell keeps in the clearing attempt. Back to the half wall for Lowne. Russell left point, slides it right wing. Trazer the shot. Nice blocker there by Aslandis. Now it's back to the line for Russell, left point. Drazer with a shot, rim of the circle. Big rebound in front. Graham trying to stop that. It's still loose. Where's the puck? It's on the right post. Lowne has it now in the corner. Back up top at 5-on-5. Drazer's shot at the line is immediately blocked. Down to the corner it goes. Lowne near wing to the far wing for Nyes. Back to the line, Drazer. Left point, Russell. Down to the corner. Lowne gave it up for Adderd as Lowne will skate this one up the half wall. Left point, Russell slides it right wing. Drazner walks in and circles back. Left point for Russell. Cross ice feed to the far circle for Nyes. Good ozone time here for Miami. Left point, Russell rips one way wide of the net. Back to the half wall for Drazner, who will send this one behind the Bronco cage. It is Lowne in the near corner as Poland emerges on him. Lowne able to skate it to the far side. He got a tired 5 players out there for the Broncos. A play in front for Phil Nyes. The shot saved by the right pad of Aslanidis. Monty Graham. As Miami continues to cycle through changes, the Broncos have been out there for a good amount of time. Behind the net, Savage after a Graham failed shot attempt. Redhawks keep it in as Drazner for a second able to play it to the near circle of the zone, but it went off the skate of Poland. And the Broncos will clear all the way down the ice and behind Pearson.
And that's a big clear there for the Broncos to just get a change, and now they got a fresh set of guys to deal with this Miami rush.
Over the line on the right wing comes Barry, the chip behind the Bronco net to the near corner for Joyall. Up the near wing boards is Granger and Tim Washi crash in for it. Fiedler behind the net to the far corner, feeds it up the left wing boards all the way down the ice, trying to hit a pass there to Hilson Dagger. They wave off the icing as it comes up the near half wall. Cassetti back to center. Joyall with it on the right wing. Feed through the middle. Granger over the Bronco or the Miami line right wing. Will fire his shot. Top of the circle. Saved by Pearson with the glove. It goes behind the net. Where Mahalik grabs it and feeds it near corner here for Capstick. The cross ice feed to the right wing. Savage over the line will fire a big shot. Pad saved by Bricky with the right side pad. Comes to the near wing for Granger, through the middle, Glover, tripped up there by Clement. They'll play on as Clement chases the puck to the far circle. Can't clear though, Hilson Dagger waiting for it at the far point of the Western Michigan offensive zone. Able to cycle it down behind the net. Glover for Clement to wrap around the boards. Hilson Dagger keeps it in, left point, the shot to the middle. Saved here by Daskey in front of his net. And they feed it left wing at center as Barbolino will get it behind the cage for Aslanidis. The wrap to the far half wall where Gilling tries to stuff it forward in the zone. He can past a few Western Michigan players. Nielsen Dagger was there as the puck comes back to the left point of the Miami zone. Daschke with it to the middle for Sladek as it was off the skate of Van Oss, and Glover, right wing at center, will dump this one behind the net. Pearson waiting for it there. Clement up the right wing boards, chipped off the stick of Sladek, back to the left point. Adder wraps it around from there to the near wing. Poland can't get the clearing attempt from Daschke, who will skate this one up the near wing of his own zone. Barbolini at center, cross his feet off his skate, looking for Gilling on the right wing. It's back in the Miami end. Clement to the near circle for Daschke, returns to Clement. And through the middle comes Adder here to the middle of the ice. Daschke to the left wing over the Bronco line. Pletsky opens up for a rush. His shot went off his stick to the far half wall. Adder back to the middle. Pasilt, or it's chipped away by Pletsky. Starts to rush the other way. Pletsky will go over the line to the left wing. Hits the brakes at the half wall. Can't get it back to Russell. Little turnover here as Pletsky tries to battle the other way, but Paul Washi comes away with it near circle. Hits the brakes in front, looking for Pasil, but couldn't catch the pass. Wide open on the left post. Loud in the zone end, chips it ahead. Monty Graham, the pass way too far in front of him, but he beats out the icing. Could have been a breakaway there. Two Broncos collide in the far circle, going for the puck. It's at the left wing at center. Drew Warad skates it and dumps it into the far corner of the Miami zone. 14-13 to go here in the second. Behind the net, it's Graham in the corner. Chips it off the boards, back to the middle. Frank with Graham. Warad over the line on the right wing for Western Michigan. In the circle, back to the slot. Frank had it stripped away. Savage could not get control of it in the corner. Warad has it as he will try to hit Larkin in front. Now Frank in the far corner for the Broncos. Takes it behind the net. Ethan Frank off the boards. Back to the line for Bricky. Fake the slap shot. The puck caroms to the corner, where Cassetti skates it out of the Miami zone up the right wing. And Dresner jibs it behind the Bronco net from the right wing at center. That's Lanidis to the near wing for Barry. The back to the line for Capstick. His shot deflects to the far half wall. And now in the corner, Bricky far side, the chip off the glass, back to center. Rehnquist played it in front. Here comes Tim Washio, the line the other way. He's one against three, but able to get to the net through the near circle. Nice pad save there by Pearson on his drive to the cage. Granger near corner, Western offensive zone. We'll take it behind the net, up the far half wall. Play to the far corner, Hillebrand slides it up to the left point. The pass picked off by Barry. His picked off again through center. And it's added in his own end for Western Michigan. Try to play it ahead. Barry intercepts over the Bronco line right away. Allowed a drive top of the far circle. Goes off the stick of Aslanidis and out of play with 12:51 to go in the second. No score between Miami and Western Michigan. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. One to go in the second. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley back with you here in Oxford. No score between Miami and Western Michigan. Pretty close affair between these two teams this afternoon. Face off to the left of Aslanidis in the Western Michigan zone. Broncos quickly work it back through center and beyond. Near corner, Daschke will grab it for the RedHawks to wrap up the near wing boards. Where Miami grabs control coming out of their near circle and off the far half wall. Gilling plays it all the way down the ice past the stick of Phil Nice. Broncos working in their own end. Paul Washey intercepted there by Dashke. Here's Fulp. Feeds Paul Washey, right wing at center ice. The dump in around behind the net where Pearson stops it there for Gilling. Near corner, Dashke. Through the middle comes Jack Clement. Over center and then over the Miami line on the right wing. Back for Nyes. Opens up. Play to the near corner. Dashke trying to work it ahead past Hilson Dagger, who will wrap it around to all the way down to the Miami zone in the far corner as nobody was at the right point. We get an icing here against Western Michigan. A clearing attempt that went all the way around the ice and down, and nobody touched it.
And Miami started off this second period really well, and they've since evened up and taken the lead in shots 11-10. Obviously something you're good to see for a RedHawk fan, something that we aren't really used to seeing for the RedHawks so far this year, being leading in shots. But the RedHawks here with 11 in the game, still yet to put one past as Landis, but 11 attempts, not too bad.
Especially compared to last night when they only had 17 in the whole game.
Absolutely.
Nice off to the right of Aslanidis. Puck comes back through center. Drasner on left wing at the red line will dump this one in back behind the Bronco net. Adder there will golf this one to the left wing at center. Old line Glover wide open in front of breakaway Van Oss. Backhand, forehand. Great save by Pearson with a pad. Here comes Pletsky over the line to the left wing. Through the circle as a line with him. Pletsky can't get the pass over. Hilson Dagger blocked it. Pletsky again in the corner. Another feed that was blocked. Trying to go high slot. Rush the other way. Glover over the Red Hawk line right wing. A shot top of the near circle. Deflects up and out of play with 11:21 to go in the second. He had a 3-on-0 the other way, Luke, and Ludwig Pearson showing off there with a great rob of the Van Oss chance.
Yeah, he was locked in on that one. Brett Van Oss comes in after that puck was chipped by the Miami defender. You said he went backhand, forehand, kind of came across the net. Pearson came with him all the way, and there was no chance for Van Oss in that jamming attempt.
And the draw will come to the left of Pearson here with 11:20 now left in the second. War out of the corner with a puck for Western Michigan. We'll leave it there as Cassetti goes down. They both try to go after it in the middle of the ice. Warad for Frank, far side. Can't connect to Warad again. Trying to come over the line, left wing, then a steal. Frank, breakaway from center, in on goal. Nice save by Pearson, the shot on the ice. He made the save with a left pad again. Not the best shot for Frank, but still a save on a breakaway attempt. And Miami with a puck back to center ice. Joyall plays it to Gallant, right wing at center. Barry takes over there on the loose puck. Slides it through the middle of the ice. Right wing at center, Savage. The dump behind the Bronco net as Landis gives it up for Joyall. The long stretch pass hits the left wing Miami line as Hillebrand chipped it off his stick and it came in on net. And Ludwig Pearson again coming up big to keep this a scoreless game.
Yeah, another great save by Ludwig Pearson. And Miami's got to be careful here. With Western Michigan, they'll stretch a guy on the far side and then he'll draw contact when he gets that puck and just chip it in behind. They've already picked up two breakaways in the last couple minutes off that, so Miami got to be careful here to cover the open man.
Fulp, left point, and we'll slide this one down to the far side as Gilling gave it up for Clement, back behind the net for Dashke. Wraps it around the boards, back to center. Granger over the Miami line, left wing again as they enter the zone. Fulp kept in a clearing attempt left point. And it's back in the Miami zone here as Dashke off the near wing boards to center. Gilling up ahead. Barbolini over the line left wing. He was stripped of the puck. Granger near circle off the boards and around to the far wing for Tim Washey, who plays it ahead. And Glover sends it behind the Red Hawk net. Pearson for Dashke. The wrap around the board to the far wing. Phil Nyes slides it left wing at center. Grant over the line on Van Oss. Takes it middle. The shot there is sticked out of play by Aslanidis. Aslanidis. And we get a timeout with 9:40 to go in the second. No score, Miami and Western Michigan past the halfway point of the game. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio.
Yeah.
begins in the second period. Miami and Western Michigan are scoreless on the ice, game two of the series. Patrick Geshan, Luke West Poley with you here on Red Hawk Radio. Thanks for joining us on this Saturday afternoon. As Miami trying to climb back in the series after falling to the Broncos 4-1 last night on this sheet of ice. Draw to the left of Aslanidis. Behind the net, Ben Lowne for Hilson Dagger. Wraps it around the board to the near wing. Poland will send it out to center. Miami takes control there. Drazda right wing. Sends it to Pletsky. The chip over the Bronco line, middle of the ice. Basalt near wing. Chip forward. Here's Poland over the line on the right side. As he will give it up for Russell to play to the far corner. Drazda on it there for Miami. Plays it through the circle. Lowne the chip back to center. And Pletsky will play this one to the near corner, whereas Lanidis wraps it around the boards through the far wing, and Pasilt is on it there. Paul Washi through the middle, intercepted by Cassetti, who sends it back to his own end, and Drazner on it for the Redhawks. Means it ahead to chip through the center ice. Cassetti to the far corner, Hilson Dagger on it. Left it there for Bricky. Now Paul Washi around the boards to the far wing, where Pasilt chips it out and down the ice and into the Miami zone. Dashke behind the net. Gives it back for Clement through the far circle. Clement feeds it middle. Berry through center ice. Over the middle of the Miami line. Left wing Cassetti in the middle. Chassie, a big shot there. Pat saved by Aslanidis. And now it is Joyal who plays this one back out of the zone. Gallant to Frank through center, over the Miami line, through the far circle. A nice little shot there, went up and out of play as it deflected off Pearson's stick with 8:12 left in the second. And the shots are 13-12 in favor of Miami. Faceoff battle is being won by the Broncos 15-11 tonight. Draw one to the right there of Pearson. Turnover immediately though. Barbellini a rush the other way. Probably will be one against three. Trying to deke his way through the left circle. They crash into the net. The faceoff will stay in the zone as Barbellini trying to skate through three Broncos. He eventually ended up crashing into the goal to knock it off the moorings. Everybody is okay down there. But the draw will stay inside the zone as Barbellini was kind of pushed into the net there from behind by a defender coming in, and I think that was Western Michigan's Ethan Frank. Kind of a weird play there.
Yeah, Barbellini, as you mentioned, had that one on three, and he was able to kind of pull that puck across his body and get it past the first Western player. And when he tried to put that on net, that's when he kind of fell, and the whole scene ensued in front of the net. But now just an offensive zone faceoff for the Redhawks.
Capstick wraps it around to the far corner. Warad was on it. Sticked up there with Graham. Pletsky and him tie up for it. Graham to the far circle. Ben Lowne, the chip back behind the net. Pletsky on it with Warad and Fiedler. Fiedler up the far wing, off the glass, back to center. Capstick loves it down there. Feeds it to the near wing for Mahalik. Up the boards, kick free by Graham. Back to center. Here's Gallant through the middle. Feeds it right wing, over the line, Warad. Hit the brakes at the half wall, the play to the corner. Capstick left it back. Here's Lowne, far half wall, chip to the middle. Nice shot there by Gallant. Feeds it up in the air. Glover top of the far circle, off its zone, shoots it up on Ben Lowne, who collapses immediately. The puck was in him. Lowne gets up okay as the puck emerges. Redhawks trying to get it back through center. Rome right way at the red line, chips it in to the Miami zone behind their net. Redhawks clear it from there up the right wing at center. Lowne, Fulp in the middle. Left wing red line will chip this one to the near circle. Graham up through the middle. Went off the stick of Adder to the far corner, and Fulp will grab it there for the Broncos. Sends it off the middle boards at center. Over the line, here's Pasilt. Left wing for the Broncos at the point. Skates it down the half wall with Barbellini. Now it's Adder, far half wall. Playing in front for Rome, the chip over the net. And Phil Nye's clearing attempt will go up and out of play as Austin Kane, the backup goaltender for Western Michigan, has it in his gloves. 6:38 to go in the second, no score.
That was an interesting sequence on the far side. You said Ben Lowne, after blocking that shot, collapsed in pain. Ty Glover was giving him the business, as they show on the board here. We hope Lowne's okay. He did finish his shift, but looked a little bit to be wincing when he was coming off the ice. So a tough shift there for Ben Lowne, but he was able to come off under his own power and finish the shift.
Pass all behind the net. Paul Washi trying to stuff it in on the left pad of Pearson, who made the save. Nines in the far corner, off the high glass, back to center for the RedHawks. Barbellini gloves it down over the line. Nice play by Hilsendagger to knock him off the puck as they entered the zone. Hilsendagger will lift this one back to center. Left wing Passalt went off his stick. Drasner with it behind the Miami net. Skates it to the near corner. Russell left it behind the cage to the far wing where Nice let it go off his stick. Paul Washi back for Gillian, and now it's at center. Bricky, the right wing, dump in around behind the Miami net to the far corner. Drasner with it there, leaves it behind the cage. Russell tosses it back to the corner, picked off though on its way to Drasner, coming into Western Michigan. Far circle, Larkin slid it in front, past the stick there of Tim Washi. Granger in the near corner, leaves it for Larkin. Behind the net, Tim Washi in the circle. Far side, a little shot came in. It didn't reach the net necessarily from Fiedler. And the puck back to center here with 5:33 to go in the middle period. Larkin for Granger, hit over the Red Hawk line. Russell takes over there, the feed to center, off the stick of Savage to the far corner. Whereas Laney descends it to the near wing, it is Joy all to send it to the far corner where Cassetti ties up for the puck, wins the battle. Barry and Savage in there for Miami, a 2-on-2 scrum in the far corner of the offensive zone. Fiedler comes away with the puck. Larkin chips it to center. Granger in a 2-on-1 the other way with Joyal. It's a breaks left point. The feed to the middle. Nice pickoff there by Cassetti, who was back-checking. Daschke up ahead, 2-on-1 Miami. Over the line, Savage to the middle. Barry wide open in front. The backhand play saved by Islandidis with his pads. And here comes Fulp as you hear the Western Michigan fans making noise. He was stripped to the high slot. Now Gallant, left point of the Miami zone. The shot, far circle, way over the cage. Back to the right point for Adderd. War out of the corner. Came through the middle, far circle, Gallant, spin around shot. Nice save by Pearson. War out of the corner, spins around with a puck, skates it up the far boards. Back to the line for Fulp. Middle of the ice, his shot breaks Daschke's stick in half as he was blocking it. Miami back to center. Adderd will send it to the middle. Cassetti lost it off his stick on the pickoff. Now a bouncing puck middle of the ice. Savage will skate it up the left wing and over the line. Trouble there for the Red Hawks. They'll get five fresh legs out as they dump it from Savage on the left wing. Frank trying to play it up the half wall. Can't. Lowne, right wing, will send it in. Big save, big rebound. They score! Monty Graham! Makes Miami drop first blood. It's 1-0 RedHawks. Picking up a big rebound there in front of the net. And the junior out of Hanover, Massachusetts with his second goal of the year. RedHawks lead it 1-0.
Well, the puck moving way up and down the ice. This is the type of situation where we would have to take a breath if there were a lot of fans here. This place would have been rocking, but after pair of chances on both sides, Monty Graham able to just change the angle a little bit on the rebound shot and put this one past Islandidis, and now the RedHawks have a 1-0 lead.
18, puck up over the line here on the left wing, and we get a whistle for what might be a high stick against, looks like Western Michigan here. So the goal scored by Monty Graham. They're still working on finding the assist. We'll get those to you when we come back. 3:45 to go here in the second. 1-0 Miami on the Monty Graham goal. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. 3:45 to go here in the second. 1-0 lead for Miami over Western Michigan. Shots are 16-14 in favor of the RedHawks. So the goal was scored by Monty Graham. The assist, the only assist on the goal, was given to Chase Pletsky. Over the line on the right wing, pass Zill to the middle. Or was turned over to Paul Watchy. Phil Nye's getting in his way to break it up. Bricky here through center ice. Killing will chip it in front. Barbalay, breakaway chance, and a nice save there on the snapshot by the pad. Neves landing this, his right side of his body. Killing the play up ahead. We'll take it back in his own zone. The feed right wing for Rehquist at center. Chips it middle of the Bronco line for Lowne to the near corner. It goes off the glass back for Poland. Slides it left wing past Zolt. Got it off his skate. Hilson Dagger, the wrap around the boards to the near half wall. As Graham and Rome tie up, Rome wins the battle. Near circle, the play to the far corner. Lowne will get the puck for the RedHawks to take it behind the net. As Dashke on it here for Miami. Leans it up the near wing boards. Pletsky back to center as Joyall was on it. Pletsky will play this one to the far side at the half wall. Grabbed by Joyall. It will slide this one all the way down the ice and behind the net. Trying to hit a pass on the right wing for Lowne. An icing call though against the RedHawks with 2:39 to go in the second. And a 1-0 Miami lead. You've had Ludwig Pearson play tremendous tonight, making some very good saves to keep this scoreless in the Western Michigan column, and the RedHawks breaking through finally with that goal here late in the second by Graham. Draw one to the left of Pearson as they tie up for it along the near half wall. Ben Lowne in the corner. Back behind the net to the far side. Chips it off the glass. Graham let it go for Fulp. This one chipped ahead. Lowne with it. Left point. Slides it right wing at center for Graham, who lost it to the middle. Here's Frank. Top of the near circle. Frank will take it to the corner and back behind the net. Feeds it left point. With it there for Western Michigan was Gallant. Leaves it back for Radford, center point, and the circle point blank chance as he skated it right in close to the net, and Pearson will make the save in the breadbasket. 2 minutes even left in the second. And Ludwig Pearson, Luke, we've talked about it in the beginning of the game and all throughout the game today, has been phenomenal.
Yeah, you know, every time you think this guy just, he must have to take a game off at some point, right? And he just hasn't. Every single game, it just seems like he's more and more locked in. He just seems really, really focused. He's really calm in the net. You know, breakaways, anything like that, they don't really seem to phase him too much. And he stands his ground really well. Another nice save there on that last sequence.
So Ludwig Pearson had what maybe was a helmet issue. He was able to fix it himself. Draw coming to his left. Cassetti and Tim Washi square off in it. Granger here near half wall. The Western Michigan offensive zone gave it up. And a 4-on-2 the other way. Barry, Russell left wing in the circle. Slid it through, but nobody home to get the pass. Savage was 3 feet behind it. Barry in the corner, near side of his zone. Left point Cassetti, the shot wide of the net. It bounced to the near corner where Granger sends it to the far half wall. Larkin will skate it out for the Broncos. The chip over the line on the left wing and back behind the net as it is grabbed here by Russell. The wrap around the board to the right point for Bricky. Granger on it for Western Michigan. And the near half wall will stake this one to the far half wall where now Russell with it in the corner for the RedHawks. Fiedler. Near wing for Joyall. Up the right wing boards. Over the line. Here comes Paul Washi for Western Michigan. Back to the middle. Joyall with a shot in the middle. Saved there by Pearson. Barbalini back the other way in a rush. Over the line. He'll skate it in the far circle. The shot wide of the net. And Barbalini this time will try to dump it deeper in the zone, but it goes up and out of play with 55.8 seconds left here in the second. 1-0 Miami lead over Western Michigan. Shots are 18-15 in favor of the RedHawks. These two teams wrapping up a series of four meetings in the last 8 days. Two of them occurring in Kalamazoo last weekend and two of them here in Oxford this weekend. Faceoff win by Western Michigan. They sent it all the way down the ice after the draw. It's an icing as Fiedler cycled it around the far boards all the way down. And I think kind of a botched play there by the Broncos. If a draw comes all the way back down the ice to the right of Aslanidis. Miami selects. Of course, the new thing this year, you can select where you want the faceoff to be, what side on icing calls and penalty calls. Lonnie Graham, clean win, back to the left point for Daschke, and the rip there from the line is into the glove of Aslanidis. How big of an advantage does that provide?
I don't know. I mean, it's interesting. It's definitely going to keep goaltenders honest. Make sure that goaltenders are balanced on both sides of their body. But I think only time will tell, you know, how many chances we're going to see off faceoffs, how much this is really going to provide an advantage for both teams.
Graham let it go to the half wall. Ben Lau down in the corner with it. Up for Graham. He takes it down through the corner for Miami. Slides it up the left wing boards. Clement down low to the half wall. Lau chipped it away. Warat gave it up to the middle. Brock goes over the line on the right wing. Here's Rome, middle of the ice. The shot, Pat St. Pearson with the right arm leg. And it goes to Pletsky, who's off the high glass, back to center and beyond. Grabbing it here is Fulp in the circle. Slides it left wing. Glover chipped to the corner behind the net. Behind the net is Van Oss. Playing it up for Daschke. Clement trying to dig in there for it as well. Near circle, the play to Adder, right as the buzzer sounds, who had a shot from point-blank range, top of the near circle. That goes over the net, and Ludwig Pearson, and we end the second period with a 1-0 Miami lead. And Luke Westpoole, your thoughts after 40?
I think there was a lot more offense from both teams, and the goaltenders on both sides have been really, really good. You know, if we were to play out that period again with as many chances, I think we'd see three, maybe four goals up on the board. But the goaltenders standing strong for both these teams. Miami, though, fortunately for them, was able to break through once. They had a couple more chances. I thought Matthew Barberlini was really good in that period, really had a knack to finding those loose pucks. Got a couple kind of half breakaway chances that he could maybe build on going into the third. But I think if that period plays, if the third period plays out like we just saw that one play out, we're in for an exciting finish.
I agree with you on that. 1-19-16, the shots are led by the RedHawks. After 40, you have 0-2. Miami is on the power play today. Broncos are 0-1 on the power play. Faceoffs are being won by the Broncos 22-14 in this matchup. Miami with 9 block shots to Western Michigan's 4. 4 penalty minutes for the Broncos, 2 for the RedHawks. Your scoring summary in that second period, there was just one goal. It came 16:03 into the period. Monty Graham on a big rebound, clean up his even strength second goal of the year, assisted by Chase Pletsky. They add an assist on that goal to Ben Lau. So it's Graham from Pletsky and Lau with 16:03 into the second on Miami's first goal of the night. And again, your out-of-town scoreboard here in the NCHC this evening. Just one other game. It starts at 7 o'clock, the top of the hour. St. Cloud battles Minnesota Duluth in Duluth at Amsoil Arena. Tomorrow there's actually one game scheduled. North Dakota and Colorado College will play in the Springs. That series kind of messed up. There are some COVID issues there going on. So they will start their series tomorrow night at 9 o'clock Eastern time at the World Arena. And then Monday night will play as well. North Dakota and Colorado College will battle at the Broadmoor World Arena. That's all we really need to update you on here after two periods of play. 1-0 Miami leads it over Western Michigan. Should be a very exciting third period, and we'll have about a 12-minute break or so before that begins. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Second intermission. Stay with us.
don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot, tech the style. I flip the script so it can't get filed. At least not now, it'll take a while. I change the pace to complete the beat. I drop the bass to MCs get weak. For every road they trace is a scar they keep. Cause when I speak, they freak to sweat the technique. I made my debut in 86 with a melody and a president's mix. And now I stay on target and refuse to miss. And I still make hits for beats, parties, clubs, and cars and jeeps. My underground sound vibrates the streets. MCs wanna beef, then I play for keeps. When they sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Know how many bombs have I ripped and wrecked, but researchers never found all the pieces yet. Scientists try to solve the context, philosophers are wondering what's next. Pieces took the lab to observe them, they couldn't absorb them, they didn't deserve them. My ideas are only for the audience ears, my opponents it might take years. Pencils, pens, and swords, letters put together from a key to chords. I'm also a sculptor, born with structure, because of my culture I'm a perfect destructor. Style that'll be full of technology, complete sights and new heights after I get deep. You don't have to speak, just see and peep the technique. But don't sweat the technique. I speak in the street cause talk is cheap. Then I get deep in the beat, think complete. Composed with the seat, never weak or obsolete. They never grow old, techniques become antique. Better than something brand new cause it's original. In a wild style I have much more value. Classical, too intelligent to be radical. Masterful, never irrelevant, mathematical. Here's some soothing souvenirs for all the years. You fought to sort the thoughts and ideas. It's cool when you freak to the beat, but don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique.
One nothing, Miami leads it over Western Michigan. About to begin our third period of play here from Oxford, Ohio. Patrick Geshan, Luke West-Poley back with you here on Red Hawk Radio for what should be an exciting last 20 minutes of play between the Red Hawks and the Broncos in the final game of this series. Luke, what are you looking for here in these first few moments of the last 20 minutes?
Well, I'm hoping for more of the same offense we saw from both of these teams, and maybe we'll see if either of these teams can finish just a little bit more. They had a lot of chances last period on both sides, but both goaltenders staying strong. Miami with the only tick up on the scoreboard so far.
Play came down the right wing after the center ice draw. Casey Gilling sent the puck out of play, trying to dump it into the Broncos zone. So the draw on the Bronco left wing closest to their blue line. Paul Washey and Casey Gilling in it. And a clean win back to Josh Passalt as Western Michigan will get this one deep into the Miami zone. Pearson gives it up for Daschke. Western Michigan in front with a chance. Point blank as Pearson took his time for getting behind the net back to his cage. Quick little play in front is in the far corner as Washey gave it right to a chance by Jason Poland. Point blank chance. Pearson turned around just in time to make the save.
Yeah, this is a broken play. Pearson kind of runs into Daschke and fans on his initial attempt to kind of ring this around. And after the turnover, he's got to come back in and recover and make the save. So good recovery by Pearson to stay perfect on the night.
25 seconds into the third period. Along the near wing is Franks, gains it up the near wing boards. Pass to the middle, Cassetti leaves a pass up for Savage. Breakaway in on goal, Ryan Savage scores! Snapshot over the glove side of Aslanidis. On a great feed ahead, and Ryan Savage makes it a 2-0 Red Hawk lead. 19:23 to go in the third period.
And this is just how this game has gone. There's been a couple of seams that have opened up inside the Broncos defense a couple of times, and with the Redhawks breaking out of the zone, just slipping through was Ryan Savage, completely unnoticed. And when he gets the breakaway, I'm sure he's one of the Redhawk players you'd really want on a breakaway if you could pick anybody up and down the roster, and Ryan Savage converts to extend this lead to 2.
Icing here on the Redhawks from their own end. So the sophomore out of Montreal, who had a power play goal last night for the Redhawks, tallies again this evening. On a great stretch pass up ahead, the assist will go to Joe Cassetti. That's the only one so far. Second of the year for Savage, making his 10th appearance of the year today. Redhawks in the near circle will clear this one out of their own end, but into their bench. And the faceoff here will stay at neutral ice on the Miami right wing, closest to their blue line. You have Monty Graham and Tim Washi scoring off in this draw. And a clean win back for Clement to the far circle for Daschke. Plays it ahead, left wing. Pletsky the chip to the far circle of Miami zone in the corner. Graham hit hard by Tim Washi. Ben Loun joining the party as well in the battle as Pletsky and Bricky try to come away with a puck. Now Graham goes down behind the net along with Van Oss as they were battling for it. Graham to his feet in the near corner. Loun the wrap around the board to the left point. Stopped there by Daschke. The rip that went off the stick of Bricky and into the netting behind Aslanidis. 2-0 Miami, 18:42 to go in the third. Shots are 20-17 in favor of the Redhawks. And the Redhawks will throw out their first line today of Barbolini, Gilling, and Nyes. With this draw coming up to the right of Aslanidis. Barbolini can't win the faceoff. Westert clears it back to center. Dumped in by number 29 in white and behind the net for Joyo. Gets it to the far side. Van Oss over the Bronco line on the right wing. The Red Hawk line, beg your pardon. Stripped away there by Capstick and back to center it goes. Barbolini through the middle, 2-on-1. Gilling with Nyes. Gilling left circle over to Nyes. The backhand shot from the right point, the right wing rather. And a save there by Aslanidis in the pads. Capstick will get out the 9-iron to put this into the near corner of the Western Michigan zone from the left wing at center. Joyall up the right wing boards. It is Rome who will stuff this one to the far corner of the Bronco zone and back behind their net. Trapped here by Barry, feeds it left wing. Russell with Paul Washi. They tie up for the puck. It goes behind the net. Drazner in there as well. Washi comes away with it. The play in front. Shot by Adder. Came in from the line. Big save Pearson. And the rebound cleared down the ice. Back to get it is Adder to the zone end for Fulp. Through the middle, chipped into the far corner by Poland and behind the cage. Here's Pearson, near corner of the pass, miss Russell as Basalt came in. And this one will go cross ice to the far side as Adder grabs it at the blue line, a play to the middle for Poland. Over the line on the right wing, Barry came in, crashing there. Basalt behind the net. To the corner, he and Loun will tie up as they skate it up the near half wall. Cassetti, the chip to center. Poland left wing at center ice. Spins around at the line, will dump this one in from center behind the net, and Pearson grabs it for Miami. Pass to the far corner, here's Daschke. Slides it middle of the ice, Clement off the near wing boards. Loun will continue the play down behind the Western Michigan net. Aslanidis behind his cage for Gallant. In the center, Frank. Far wing controlled here by Pletsky. He'll give it up for Clement. The play down the boards to the near circle of Western Michigan zone as Bricky will give it up for Gallant. Play up the wing. Here's Nye. Slides at left point. Capstick. The drive from there wide left of the net. Rydquist came in but can't steal it away from Frank, and it's Nye's back through the middle where Capstick will send this one in from the left wing at center to hit our good friend Eric Frank, the linesman. Up the near wing, here's Sladek in the offensive zone, down to the corner for Barbolini. Bricky gave it up, Barbolini to the line, Rydquist fires it wide of the net right. Far half will it go, Sladek to the line, Capstick, a slap shot from the left point. It is into the glove of Aslanidis. .1602 remains in the third. A 2-0 Miami lead over Western Michigan. Draw comes to the right of Tim Washey. Barrion Washey in the draw. Goes to the top of the circle. Cassetti fired it. But into traffic. Savage near half wall. Plays it to the middle. Slid it across. Barry there. The pass behind him. Puck sent to the right point. Drazner keeps it in there from the corner. Able to hit Barry for a pass. He was tripped up. Spin around play though to keep it in at the line to the corner. Here's Savage coming up the half wall with a puck. Slides it over for Drazner. Down the board. Scam it for Cassetti. Barry is leveled from behind the Western Michigan net by Joyall. And we'll get a penalty from that. And a power play is upcoming here to the Red Hawks. Barry up on his own power. Seems to be okay, but it will be Michael Joyall to the box for Western Michigan. What was a pretty blatant hit from behind, Luke?
Yeah, they're going to review this one. Barry went pretty hard in, and you can immediately tell as soon as a guy's helmet kind of tweaks around like that when he falls face first into the boards, you know that, A, there's a penalty imminent. As soon as you look to the official, he had his arm up right away. I mean, that's the easiest call he's going to make all day, but now it's decision time on whether or not Michael Joyall is going to have to sit for 2 or 5 or maybe even be done for the rest of the 15:34 we have left to play. Michael Joyall, guy whose family knows this program very well, of course.
Yep. Older brothers Matt and Chris played at Miami. Chris all 4 years. Matt transferred to Ohio State after a couple of years here at Miami, but Chris, a Miami grad, played on some of those really good teams in the mid-2010s, the CCHA championship team, I believe, in 2012-13. Was definitely on the NCHC playoff championship team in 14-15. That was the team that's the last time Miami made the NCAA tournament. We have our verdict. Joe Sullivan, the referee, will announce it.
Following video review, Western Michigan minor penalty, 2 minutes for boarding.
So they keep it just 2 minutes for Joyall. Do you agree?
Well, we didn't really get to see the replay too much, but something that could have influenced the decision a little bit, Matt Barry's going right back out there to start the power play here for the Red Hawks, so glad he didn't have anything serious on him, and now for the Red Hawks, it's a chance to really step on the Broncos' throat here.
Miami power play, that's 0-for-2 today. Faceoff goes to the far corner, the Bronco end. Up the near half wall, Gilling leaves it to the right point. Daschke slides it in from there. Gilling near half wall to the corner. Behind it, that's Savage off the far boards. Barry takes over. Trying to play it up ahead, but couldn't reach Savage to the corner. Clearing a tap, blocked down. Gilling from the high slot, rips it over the net. Barry far half wall back for Gilling. High in the zone, far circle Daschke in front for Savage. We'll stick it to the near wing. Gilling and Poland crash in there to the half boards for the puck. Adderton and Cassetti. Fulp down there too. Savage and Barry collide, so it's a 4-against-3 battle. Western comes away with the puck. Paul Washey will send it left wing over the line. Comes past Holt into the offensive zone. He'll play it to the corner just slowly and surely on the PK with 1:07 to go on the Miami power play. Daschke to Savage, right wing at center. The dump in behind the Bronco net. They wrap it around the near wing boards. Gilling keeps in the clearing attempt. They'll send it around to the far side where Barry sticks it to the far corner. Down there for Western Michigan, battling for the puck. And they locked it up with Tim Washey. Skates up the far wing boards. Western clears it to center. And in the center circle, Daschke with it with 40 seconds to go on the man advantage. Good opportunity here for the Redhawks to really put this thing away, possibly. up 2-0, 14 minutes left in the third. Here comes Lowne over the line of the right wing is Graham, back to the corner. Lowne the wrap around the board to the far half wall. Perry gets the pass there, skates it middle. Play to the far corner, here's Nyes through the middle of the ice. Behind the net now, Bricky turned it over from him to Gallant near half wall. The stick up ahead and Warad will chip this one down the ice and to the near corner where Russell grabs it for the Redhawks. It's the breaks behind his own net with 5 seconds to go on the power play. Lowne near wing trying to stick it to center. He is going to get over the Bronco line. Never mind. We got a penalty coming up here.
Yeah, I think Lowne got up high on Warad there.
Media timeout with 13:32 to go in the third. Lowne will go. 2 minutes for high sticking. And the Broncos with a chance to cut the lead in half with a power play when we return. 13.5 to go in the third. 2-0 Miami. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. T32 remains here in the third period. Western Michigan about to go on the power play for the second time today after the high-sticking minor to Ben Lowne. And they win the faceoff of the offensive zone. Pass Zoll to right point. Couldn't slide it past Cassetti. Back to the line. Fulp with it center point. Far circle pass Zoll to Fulp in the offensive zone for the Broncos. Trying to slide it through the middle of the slot. Redhawks take it over and Graham will play down the ice to the near corner as Landis has it. Fulp behind his cage, right wing feed, coming up the boards in the far wing, over the line for Western Michigan was Adderd. We got a whistle here for a high stick, I think Western touched it. As he was trying to go down low to pass it, and the draw will come out of the Miami zone with 1:31 to go in the power play for the Broncos.
Yeah, that's something that's gonna frustrate Andy Murray a lot. All Josh Basold had to do was let that fall to the ice, but instead just hits that with the stick and really no need. And now the faceoff comes outside the zone and now off the draw, it's gonna get sent all the way down.
Behind a Bronco net where Fulp grabs it. Skating up through the near circle, turn it over again. Nyes with Gilling with him in the zone. Gilling far circle, the shot. Nice save by Aslanidis in the breadbasket. But good transition play by the Redhawks there on the penalty kill. Nice, nice stripping for the turnover high in the zone. He used Gilling and they kind of did a 2-on-1 the other way.
Yeah, something that's really vital for forwards on penalty kills is their ability to just pounce on loose pucks. Every time a puck bounces off a guy's stick on a forecheck, you've got to take advantage of that because not only can you get a scoring chance, you can also kill some time on the penalty kill as well.
Draw to the right of Aslanidis. Puck comes to the near half wall. Glover takes it over there for the Broncos. Slides it middle. Joyal takes it behind the Bronco net. And up the near wing boards, right side of the ice. Coming down the boards, Warad to the corner. Russell down there. Let it go in the corner where it goes back to the line for Joyal, right point. With a slap shot, that would save. It goes to the near half wall. Back to the line is Frank. Center line for Joyal. Frank near circle, a rip. Shouldered away by Pearson to the far corner. Broncos still work for it there. It's in front. Pearson, one save on a shot. Another chance goes to the corner. Far circle, Gallant, 37 to go on the power play. Back to the line for Joyal. We'll step in and wait. Far circle, Warad, the Glover in front, they score! Backhand, forehand, Glover went to slide it on the ice. Past the outstretched right pad of Pearson. And with 12:01 to go in the third, a power play goal for Western Michigan makes this a 2-1 hockey game.
That was great puck movement by Western, and you could smell a goal there after a couple good opportunities for the Broncos, and a good job down low by Ty Glover. Uses his hands, he was able to pull that one out from below the goal line, get some space on the far side, and just sneak that one in past Pearson, and the Broncos have life.
So just a one-goal lead now for the RedHawks. Middle of the way here through the second, almost there. Clement near wing at center for Phil Nyes. Skates it over the line or the left wing, then hands over to Dashke to dump it behind the Bronco net to the near wing. Fulk to the far corner. Adder trying to chip it ahead. Got it out on the second effort from Washi. Now it's Fulk through center for the Broncos. Over the line on the right wing. Going through the circle. Hit the brakes at the half wall. Fulk slides it near wing. A shot by Adder. Nice pat save there by Pearson. Knocked back to the left point. Adder lays it down and back through center. Grabbed by Bricky. Through center ice. Over the line on the right wing. The dish back. Granger's drive for the right point. Blocker saved by Pearson. And it goes back to center ice where it's past Salt. Spinning around a point off the glass back to center. Dashke back for Capstick. Through the middle for Barry. The play in on Scooter Bricky. Now Paul Washi for past Salt. The other way. Little break with a shot. Nice pat save there by Pearson with the right side. And a puck in the far corner. Paul Washi behind the net. Skates it to the near wing. Dish to the top of the left circle. Pasolt, gave it back to the line. Hilson Dagger bobbles it. It comes out of the zone. Red Hawks will chase the puck and neutralize as Western controls to their own end. Hilson Dagger plays it up the right wing board. Stopped there is Paul Washi. Savage over the line on the left wing. Will open up, spin around at the half wall for Barry. Left point, here's Reichquist, the shot. Blocked down in traffic to the near corner. Pasolt to Hilson Dagger behind his net. Barry takes it over. Behind the cage, in front for Capstick, wide open in the slot, he scores! Forehand, backhand for Alec Capstick, his first point and first goal of the year. And with 10-12 to go in the third period, number 34 makes it 3-1 Miami.
That's a big goal for the RedHawks. That was an unbelievable play below the goal line by Matt Barry. He was really, really patient. He got the puck below the goal line. He waited until the opportunity was there. Drew three defenders down low for Western Michigan. And coming right down Broadway was Alec Capstick. Made a nice move at the end, going backhand to forehand. Was able to get that one around his Landis. And the RedHawks regained their two-goal lead at a critical moment.
Came right down through the middle of the slot. And was able to stick it right past his Landis. Critical goal, like you said, Luke, to give Miami the 3-1 lead, the two-goal lead back. With exactly 10 minutes now to go in the third. Western threatens and they score! Just a few seconds later, Jamie Rome will grab his first of the year. And just like that, it's 3-2 with 9:59 to go in the third. And the Western bench fired up.
Yeah, there's a lot of energy on the black jerseys right now, and that's a great way to respond, right? You score a goal, you cut the lead in half, and when it gets re-extended to two, you might as well just put it back where it was. And now Western, with the momentum that they lost, they got it right back, arguably may have even gotten some more.
Play came from the corner. Ty Glover, the centering pass for Rome, who stuffed it past Pearson. A quick little play when they got it quickly into the zone after the center ice draw following the Miami goal. 3-2, 9:40 left in the third. Redhawks to the offensive zone, left point Dashke. Far corner for Gilling on the look. Returns to the left point for Dashke at the line. Slides it around the boards behind the net. Fulk ties up there with Nyes. Fulk in the corner, coming through with it, through the circle. Here's Glover at center, chips it over the line to the near corner. And wraps it around behind the net where Dashke and Fulk collide. And then Clement trying to join the party as well, but can't. You have Gallant down there, two in the battle, two against two. Finally kicked free by Dashke to the far corner for Gilling. Back to the left wing corner for Dashke. Far half wall for Clement. Gilling over to Nyes, left wing at center. The dump in behind the cage as Landis on it there to the corner. Where it's cleared out back to center. And here comes Reichquist down the ice to chase down the Western Michigan clearing attempt that hit nobody. And an icing call here. 8:51 to go in the third. Miami with an offensive draw coming up to the left of Islanidis. As you have a line out there featuring Cassetti, Savage, and Reichquist right now. Well, Barry out there as well. Capstick on the ice. Rehquist lined up in a forward position. Broncos won the draw back. They cleared all the way down the ice again. Another icing, I think, coming up as Hilson Dagger trying to stretch it out for Gallant at center, but his attempt to lift it up and find him somewhere in the middle of the ice was too hard, so it comes all the way down the ice and draw coming up here to the left of Aslanidis.
And at a crucial moment for the Redhawks, Chris Bergeron entrusting these guys that we see towards the bottom of the lineup sheet with this play, and guys like Alec Capstick and Matt Berry, but they've been tremendous tonight, and Chris Bergeron looking to ride the momentum here.
Western here in the near corner. Bricky will take it behind the net. He ties up with Pletsky, who tampers with him. Western able to get it out, though, through center. Frank over the line on the left wing. Through the circle. Is he and Capstick tied up? Capstick, a nice hit on Frank there down low. Orad up through the far circle. Back to the line for Joyo. The shot deflected off Pletsky, sticking out of play. And we will get a timeout with 8:15 to go in the third. 3-2 the Miami lead over Western Michigan. In the third, this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Remains here in the third period, a 3-2 Miami lead over Western Michigan. Draw to the left of Ludwig Pearson, the Miami zone coming out of the timeout. It's back at center. The Broncos will regroup in their own end and flip it to the center circle. Paul Washi picks it up there, feeds it over the line on the right way for Jason Poland. Down behind the net, where it's grabbed by Drasner. Trying to slide it to the corner. Gilling reverses direction behind the Miami net. Over on the left wing for Russell, who tries a long stretch pass ahead for Phil Nyes, who beats out the ice, and they couldn't connect. The pass was over Nyes' head at the Bronco line when it got to him. Paul Washi, the dump in from center for the Broncos. Behind the net, Russell, near corner, Drasner. Flips it out, but not very strongly. Van Oss takes it over the left point. Hits the breaks far half wall. The try by Adder, he scores! From the right point, Ronnie Adder to Softy there as it went right through Ludwig Pearson. And with 7:29 to go in the third, this game is tied at 3.
And there's one that Pearson's going to want back. That's just a clean shot from the point there by, I believe that was an Adder, right?
Yep.
And Adder, yeah, just a shot, you could hear it, hit the chest protector of Ludwig Pearson. It was pretty loud shot, but then you just saw it trickle between his legs and roll into the back of the net, and now the Broncos are rolling here. The game's tied, but a lot of momentum on their side.
With 7:20 to go in the third, Adder at even strength, the assist by Brett Van Oss. And a drop coming up here to the left of Ludwig Pearson. And we'll feature Matt Berry in there against Drew Warad. Puck goes behind the net. Pulling to the left point for Adder. The shot over the net went off the glove of Pearson. It just barely trickled over the crossbar. Back to the line, Adder got a feed. In front for Gallant as Western Michigan really applying the pressure on this shift. Cassetti back to the line. It's taken into the Miami zone again. Clement Flair corner behind his net for Daschke. And we'll just wait for the Redhawks. And they get it out up the right wing. Over the line is Clement. Playing it forward, Pisani, the dump behind the cage. Learn is grabbed here by Hilson Dagger into the middle. Paul Washi over the line on the right wing. Passel barely onside there as the play goes to the corner. Here's Monty Graham behind the net. Gave it up for Capstick as he ties up along the far half wall with Paul Washi. Passel down there as well as this one will come up to the high slot. Chase Pletsky, the chip and go pass. Hilson Dagger into the Broncos zone over the line on the right wing. It came to the middle, but nobody home there on the feed from Pletsky. Pulling up the right wing boards through center and back to the far corner of the Miami zone. Russell there behind the cage. Chip free by Hampus Rydquist, who slides this one through the middle and to the far corner of the Miami end. The Bronco end, rather, and it's an icy call here. The defensive zone puck handling, Luke, has not been very good at all this year for the Redhawks, and an example of that there was six to go in the third.
Absolutely, yeah. They just aren't able to really get clean sticks on the puck there as Hampus Rydquist ices the puck, and it's going to be really, really crucial to get that reined in for the Redhawks here in the last 6 minutes. They cannot avoid any turnovers while they're trying to break the puck out.
Broncos have taken the shots lead too, 28-24. Rydquist will dump it after a defensive zone draw win all the way down the ice for another icing here as Joyal was chasing down the wing with Pletsky. Pletsky could not beat him out for the icing. So with 5:54 to go in the third, we have a 3-3 tie. Miami and Western Michigan. Redhawks led in this period at one time by a 3-1 score. And then the Broncos climbing back with 2-1 answered for the tie here. Drawn to Pearson's right, Van Oss and Graham. A clean win for the Broncos. Fulp left point shoots it off the stick of Lown, who was high in the zone. Puck deflects to the far half wall. Lown sticks it to the far boards at center where Fulp will dump it in for Western Michigan, but he was in front of the red line and an icy call here against the Broncos as they were trying to get things started. Fulp the play just in front of the red and the puck coming down the ice for an offensive zone drop for Miami with 5:38 to go in the third.
And Chris Bergeron talked a lot about going into this week, we're going to get a timeout here. It's going to be called by Western. Chris Bergeron talked a lot about coming into this week, finding a way to win and teaching this team and this program how to win again after they've gotten away from that in the past few years. And I think this is a big moment for that. You know, you're against a team that, even though it's a tie game, has a lot of momentum. Now, the mindset for the Redhawks has got to be, how can you steal some of that momentum back? What can you do? Is that through throwing pucks at the net? Is that through just trying to dump and grind? It depends on what your game is, of course. But for the Redhawks, it's just every little bit of momentum that you can steal back from the Broncos here is a win as they're looking to take the lead here in this game.
5:38 left in it, or more possibly. So the timeout called there by Andy Murray after the icing call. Just wants to make sure his troops are in good shape here before they defend in their own zone. The draw to the left of Islanidis. Gilling in it with Warad. And Warad, the clean win to Fulp in the corner, wraps it around the far boards. Gallant gets it at center. Feed to the middle, off the stick of Warad, tip to the near corner of the Miami zone. Gilling for Russell. Off the boards, near wing, could not reach Nyes. Warad ties up for it down there in the corner. Gilling comes away with the puck, finds Nyes in the near circle, who still can't get it out. Warad, the turnover, will play it to the far corner of the Western offensive zone. Here's Frank. Tied up down there with Gallant as they go to the corner in front, trying to stuff it. Pearson the save. Russell blocked the shot, but Warad point blank on the right post, and Pearson has it in his chest.
And this is going to be a big last 5 minutes for Ludvig Pearson as well. This is one of his first big tests of mental adversity here after giving up a tough goal there, yep, to tie a game after playing so well. So now Pearson really needing to just channel everything here and continue to play like he has for the Redhawks.
5:05 to go in the third. Savage coming out of the zone for Miami. The dump in from the red line at center, around to the far corner. Clement that was there. Bricky ties up below the Western net with Cassetti. Bessel and Savage tie up for it. There's a 3-on-2 battle below the goal line. Puck squirts free to the far half wall. Clement, they'll stick this one down around the board to the near corner. Savage for Passolt, out to center. Daschke has it right wing at center for the RedHawks. The dump in behind the net as Landis to the near corner. Nilsson Dagger to the far corner. Bricky up the wing. With a pass there, found Paul Washi, but the RedHawks hold the line quickly on the left side. Pletsky was taken down by Bricky very quickly. Hilson Dagger, the wrap around the boards to the near wing. Roll back to center. With not much support, stripped away there by Lowne with 4:05 to go in the third, and he will send it in on his Landis in the net, where it goes to the far half wall. Hatter, the lift to center, the lob wedge there to get it over the RedHawk line, but Glover stepped over the line before the puck came through. And it will give us a timeout with 3:55 to go in the third. We're tied at three, Miami and Western Michigan. As this one coming down to the wire here in Oxford, Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Five remains in the third period, 3-3 tie between Miami and Western Michigan. Shout out to the Virginia Geshans who are listening on Blue Roan Road right now. Thanks for tuning in on a Saturday afternoon as Miami and Western Michigan are tied at three. Paul Washi back to the far corner. Western works it out to the middle as Drazner plays it ahead. And this one will go into the penalty box from the Miami zone. So the drop coming to the left of Pearson with 3:48 left in the third. We have Paul Washi in this draw with Casey Gilling. Washi the clean win back to the right point. Fulp the shot and a glove save by Pearson from high up top in the zone. 3:43 to go in the third. This is where you really miss the crowd, Luke, because that's where they provide the energy for these moments. It really doesn't feel like a 3-3 game with 3 minutes to go.
Yeah, you know, the atmosphere in here, there really isn't a whole lot of it. With this game being, you know, so back and forth and nobody in attendance, you just wish that the RedHawks were really able to feed off the momentum of the crowd here at home while they had that advantage.
Gallant with a faceoff, one at the half wall, it come in front, and Western Michigan plays it back to the line. Fiedler sends it wide of the net on the left post. Washi down there battling with Barry behind the cage. Warad comes away with a puck for Western Michigan. Up the far half wall, back down to the corner and behind the net. Daschke and Gallant tie up for it. Gallant behind the cage, skates into the near corner, back to the line. Fiedler fan on the pass, and this will come up into the bench as Savage tried to stick up the puck out of the zone. It deflected into the tunnel next to the Miami cage. So we will get a faceoff here on the right wing. Miami's right wing closest to their blue line right in front of their bench in front of us. 3:15 to go in the third. We're tied at three. Nilsson Dagger here will play it to the right wing. Bricky chips it from center ice to the near corner. Grabbed there and sent around the boards by Lowne. He and Glover kind of tie up for it high in the zone. Graham and Lowne will dig away at it. Graham's getting it up the near wing boards to the right point, the chip to the near corner. Bricky with it behind the net, will take it to the far side, rolling behind the net. Here's Graham. He and Hilson Dagger tie up for it. Hilson Dagger, the hard hit on Graham. Lowne in there as well, trying to battle along the hash marks. Will send it around the boards to the near half wall. Rehquist was there. Here's Pletsky, right point, sends it behind the Bronco net. Graham with a puck in the near corner, trying to stick this one away. Hilson Dagger was on it too. And now it is Bricky along the far side. Got the puck for Rome. Played it up ahead. Glover at center. Chipped it to the near corner of the Miami zone. Icing here as he was in front of the red line with 2:17 to go in the third. Draw to the left of Aslanidis. Shots are 30-24 in favor of Western Michigan. Rocks really haven't added a shot in the last few minutes. Puck back to the right point. Russell to the corner. Went past Barbolini. Nyes behind the net. Hit there by Van Oss. Nyes trying to stuff it right post, but Aslanis there strong with a pad. Russell back at the center. Slides it left wing. Over the line comes Trasner. Playing it behind the net on the dump. And Aslanis there could not stretch out to stop it. Western plays it back to center ice with 1:53 to go in the third, a tie game. Healing the wrap around the boards to the near corner. Nice. Crashing in there for the puck. He came in with Pasult. Through the circle, stripped away by Gilling. Behind the Bronco net, skates it to the far corner. Back to the left point for Dashke. Waits, the shot through traffic. Went just wide of the net. Barbolini picks it up near corner. Clement right point, the shot blocked down by Pasult. High in the zone. They'll start it back through center. The left wing dump it from the red line. It comes in front of the Western Michigan bench again. And this will be an icing on Fulp as he was in front of his bench, in front of the red line, played a cross corner dump in. But nobody there to touch it. And with 1:22 to go in the third, offensive zone draw upcoming for Miami.
We'll see if Western Michigan got a change here. Miami's going to consider taking a timeout. Matt Berry waves the officials over, says, I want the draw on this side. Comes to the left of Aslanidis.
Ian Washi square off to the corner. Fulp trying to play it ahead. It goes around the board to the far half wall. Poland first to it for the Broncos in the corner. Let it go for Adder. Back to center. Here's Pasult. One against three the other way. Over the middle of the line. The shot deflected into the shin pads of Pletsky. And Pasult will get it deep behind the Miami net. Comes in the corner, Savage with time to work. Flies it to the middle where Cassetti missed the pass. Added the wrap behind the net. Pearson has it near corner for Dashke. The shovel out up for Savage who will play it through center into the Bronco zone. Berry near corner, the offensive end with 43 seconds left in a tie game in the third. Cassetti, left point, the wrap to the near corner, past the stick of Berry. Grabbed here by the Broncos and it's Frank to slide it through the left wing at center. It's sent back to the Bronco end. Adderd slides it over for Joyo. Over the line on the right wing. Let it go there at the half wall for Capstick behind the net. Capstick here in the corner. We'll skate it up through the circle. Slides it right point for Lown on the right wing rather, but it came back to the Western Michigan zone. And here come Miami out of their own end. Here's Graham, slides it left wing. Capstick over center. The dump in on Aslanidis. Poland behind his net to the near corner. Goes off high glass, 1 second to go, and that will do it here for the third. So that was kind of a weird last minute, Luke. We had possession changing between both teams. Not a whole lot of energy, I don't think, shown in that last minute or two, if you're talking about either team, and we're tied at three here after 60.
Yeah, it was interesting, as you mentioned, that last minute. Neither team really wanted to give up any sort of opportunity. This has been a game where mistakes have been pounced on all night, and I don't think either team really wanted to make that mistake. Now, is that going to please the coaching staffs? Of course not. But for the players, now they got some extra hockey to play, and 5 minutes on the clock, and they still got a chance to witness an NCAA play.
So a little two-minute break here for both teams to rest before the three-on-three overtime, and that's a new thing in college hockey this year universally, is we don't play any 5-on-5 overtime. We go right into 3-on-3 for 5 minutes. And then after that, if we're still tied, a shootout. But the 3-on-3 overtime, a lot more exciting. You got a lot more room open out on the ice. Plenty of offensive creativity can make things interesting. And everybody's got to kind of stand on their toes because that possession can change. And with the speed of the game today, that puck could be in either zone in a matter of seconds. You have to be ready on your toes.
Absolutely. And I think in this overtime, we can expect chances that just go back and forth. I think that if either team, you know, misses on a chance, it's going to go the other way. And there's going to be something that's going to happen on the other side of that. And I think that's something that the coaching staffs are going to stress here, is if you get a golden opportunity, you have to capitalize. Because not only if you miss, do you not win the game, but you've got a chance to lose the game now with the puck going the other way.
So the clock will wind down here between regulation and overtime. 3-3 your score. Western Michigan winning the shots battle in regulation 29-26. And that's been a problem for Miami all year long, Luke. They've been outshot in just about every single game this season. And it's been tough for this team to overcome deficits when you are getting outshot. So Miami throws out Casey Gilling, Matt Barbolini, Derek Daske. Western Michigan has Drew Warad, Ronnie Adderd, and Ethan Frank. Clean win for Western Michigan after the center ice draw. Miami moves right to left across your radio here in this 3-on-3 overtime period for 5 minutes. Frank over center, over the Red Hawk line, being chased by Barbolini, who knocked the puck free. He's got it in the far corner of his own end. Daske with it behind the Miami goal line, skates it up the feed to the right wing. Barbolini over the Bronco line right wing, top of the far circle, trying to make a move on Adderd, but couldn't. Barbolini here in the corner, plays it back behind the net. Frank takes over for the Broncos, sends it behind the cage for Adderd. And Western will break out of their zone as Adderd here will take his time through the circle, the far circle of his own end. Feeds it left wing after a Western change. Paul Washey over the line right wing, finds Adderd coming through the circle with a high pass there, but it missed him. Rush the other way for Miami, nice. Finding Daske in the middle, but the pass just ahead of him could have had a clean breakaway there. Back behind the net it goes. Paul Washey to the near circle. Adderd will break it out for the Broncos. Through center and over the Red Hawk line. 2-on-1. Washey in front, wide open. He gloved it over the net. Is that one wide left too of Pearson. Behind the net, coming away with a puck for a shot. Saved by Pearson as it hung there for a second. Still loose. And the whistle finally blows as Poland kind of cast his own shadow and quietly with the puck, took it in front of the net. He had three chances there on Pearson, who finally made the cover to keep this a 3-3 tie with 3:41 to go in the overtime.
Yeah, in 3-on-3 overtime, you can't make half decisions and second-guess yourself. That whole rush started because Derek Daske didn't know if he wanted to change. He made it halfway to the bench, and then another split decision there that the Redhawks were unsure about. They let a Western player right out in front. And luckily, Ludwig Pearson's able to keep this game alive.
Puck goes all the way down the ice here after a face-off win by Miami in their own end. They sent it down behind the Bronco net. Fulp will pick it up for Western Michigan in the near corner of the zone with 3.5 to go in the overtime. Fulp through center, feeds it right wing, over the line pass, Hulk, top of the near circle, cut to the middle. His rip went off the stick of Clement and over the net and out of play. So you've had the majority of the play in this overtime in the Western Michigan offensive zone. Pearson will have the draw come up to his right with 3:21 to go in the period. You have Russell, Graham, and Cassetti out there for Miami. Warad, Joyal, and maybe Frank out there for Western Michigan. Frank with a puck, top of the far circle, hits the brakes in the near circle. Far circle, Warad the shot. One-timer there, pat saved by Pearson. Far half wall, Joyal to the right wing for Frank. Leaves it at the point for Warad. Drew Warad will skate it out of the zone back to center. He didn't have any good options with Cassetti coming in on him. Joyal in his own end to center for Frank. Will circle back to neutral ice, feeds it right wing. Warad over the Red Hawk line. Will wait there, got to pass Cassetti. Down the near wing, Frank in the corner, tied up with Russell. Frank will send this one back up the wall, where Cassetti will trip it past Paul Washey. 2-on-1 the other way. Cassetti with Graham. Cassetti left circle into the zone. Will feed this one to the middle, but a great defensive play by Joyal to break up the 2-on-1 pass. 2-on-1 for Western now. Paul Washey over the right wing. Joyal left circle. Will take it back to the corner and pass it to the near circle for Paul Washey. Washey will skate it back to the middle of the ice at center in the center circle. Beats Poland over the Red Hawk line, left wing. Poland cutting to the middle, top of the near circle. Circles back at the right point, trying to get past Barbolini, who is shadowing Poland down the half wall now. Poland behind the Miami net, 2:02 to go in the overtime. Left point for Adderd with room, walks in, does not shoot it. Leaves a drop pass to the near circle for Paul Washey, and Western gently takes it back to center, and we'll get another player out there in Pesult, who is new to the regime. Passolt over the center, turns on the Jets, over the Miami line left wing, through the circle. Daske angles him to the far corner. Basalt back to the left point for Adder. Ronnie Adder walks it middle of the blue line to the near circle for Gallant. Left it there for Gilling in the corner. And Western trying to get it back high in their own end. Will send it all the way down the ice as Basalt puts it in his own zone and behind his own goal line for Fulp. Has to get it. 1:20 left in the 3-on-3 overtime. 3-3 tie between Miami and Western Michigan. Gallant turn it over at the Miami line. Here's Nyes down on a breakaway. The shot. Great glove save made by Aslanidis. In the circle, Nyes again in front. Trying to slide it through, but past the pad of Aslanidis. And wide of the net. And it comes all the way down through center to the RedHawks zone with a minute to go in the overtime. 3-3 tie. RedHawks in Western Michigan as Phil Nyes stops it behind his own net. To the far corner here for Savage. Skates it through the middle, over the line in the left wing. Savage cuts to the right side now in the far circle of the offensive zone, leaves it down the board to the far corner for Clement, who ties up down there with Frank. They try to kick it free. Warad to the corner. Joyal ties up there with Barry. As Savage came in, now Joyal with a break, and he springs Frank on a breakaway. Frank did on goal on Pearson, a bouncing puck. He shot it off Pearson's chest. And the rebound cleared. RedHawks 2-on-1. Barry and Savage. Barry near circle. The rip off the crossbar. Cleanly beat as Landis. 6 seconds to go. Western 2-on-1. Joyal right wing over to Poland. Got his glove on it, but it went over the net. And in the corner, and the buzzer sounds. We had two 2-on-1s in the last 10 seconds. Probably 5 2-on-1s in the last minute. And 3-3 tie. After the 3-on-3 overtime, so now on to a shootout.
Well, we mentioned it in the intro to overtime, in between regulation and overtime. Whole bunch of 2-on-1s showcased in that one, and the goalies stay strong. Matt Barry at the end there with a golden chance on a 2-on-1 for the RedHawks with about 15 seconds left when he fired that one off the crossbar. That one rebounded hard the other way, allowed the Broncos to get a break. They weren't able to finish either, with that one being shot just over the net. A tie officially, yep, outside of conference, but now some pride on the line and a conference point as well as we head to the shootout.
So this will decide just more points in the league standings. Both teams get 1 point, so the shootout will give 2 points to the winning team. So Miami 3, Western Michigan 3. That was a great overtime period that we saw, in the Western Michigan controlling the possession for the majority of it. So Miami will shoot from our left to our right here in this shootout. It is a 3-round shootout, so not sudden death. And the RedHawks, I don't know who's going to shoot first here. We're trying to figure that out.
The team that scores the most goals with their three shooters will be declared our shootout winner. Should the teams remain tied after each of the first six
shooters? There's nobody out there yet for either team to begin things. The puck is sitting at center ice. We will see. So teams are awarded 3 points for each conference win in regulation, 2 points for an overtime or shootout win, so I beg your pardon. So Miami and Western Michigan both just got a point in the overtime, and now they're competing for another point in the league standings. Basalt, the first shooter for Western Michigan. Forehand, backhand, the left-handed shot, got it in past Pearson, who was on his belly, and Basalt able to get it over him. So Western with a 1-0 lead.
First to shoot.
To the bottom of the first, Savage. Will come here for the RedHawks as their first shooter. Picks up the puck at center. Down the middle of the ice. The wrist shot wide left of Aslanidis. And after one round, it's 1-0 Western. Next shooter will be Ethan Frank for the Broncos out of Papillion, Nebraska. A state every team in the league knows well by now. Frank comes in with a shot, top right corner of the net. He beat Pearson over his shoulder. And the Broncos now forcing Miami to have to score in this round to continue things, as Matt Barry in the bottom of the second will have to score here to keep it alive. Berry picks up the puck at center. Over the line to the far circle, cutting to the middle. The wrist shot saved by Islanidis, and Western Michigan will grab the extra point in the shootout. They'll win it by a score of 4-3 today over the Miami RedHawks. And Western Michigan will take the majority of the points in this weekend series over Miami. They will grab 5 points on the weekend out of the 6 total available. And the Broncos putting together, Luke, what was a pretty impressive come-from-behind performance to take the majority of points out of this one.
Yeah, this is a really impressive showing from the Broncos down the stretch. And they would not be denied in the shootout. Just 2 rounds, all it took for the Broncos to win it. They looked really, really strong in that shootout. And they'll pick up the extra point.
Stay with us in just a moment. We'll have
in the NCHC standings. And
the game.
Sure, it's going to be a fun bus ride back to Kalamazoo for the Broncos.
Yep. The 4.5 hours back up there will be a good one for them, for the RedHawks. Meanwhile, it is a tie, and ties are not wins, but they're not losses. It's kind of a weird feeling after the game, but this thing kind of really puts a stamp on it for the RedHawks, as you're at home against a very beatable team, and you only come out with 1 point on the weekend. That's got to sting for a Miami team who next weekend welcomes in a top five team in the nation in Minnesota Duluth.
Absolutely, and you know, when you have a 2-goal lead against a team like this, you got to keep it if you're the RedHawks. And like you mentioned, in this league, I mean, the teams are just too good. As we're going to see a top 10 team come to Oxford next week in the Duluth Bulldogs, still technically 2-time defending national champions, and they've still got a, you know, tremendous team. They can still win another national title this year. It seems like we say that every single year about the Bulldogs, and you know, they're a really, really good team, and the RedHawks cannot afford to take any periods off like they did here today, as well as yesterday. And it's going to be a tough weekend next week for the RedHawks. Got to get some things worked out in practice if they're going to want to pick up any points on the weekend.
And that will be a big challenge against the Duluth team next weekend, who again is playing St. Cloud right now. I believe they have dropped a puck at Amsoil Arena, and they are scoreless right now between St. Cloud State and Minnesota Duluth. So technically the score is the 3-3 tie, but Western Michigan with a shootout win, so they get the most points in the league standings as the RedHawks and Broncos skate on the ice this weekend. So it's fun, Luke. Glad you could be on with me today, and hopefully Miami can find something here. What do you think their biggest problem is going into the next few weeks of the season?
I think it's just the stretches where we see big lapses in play. I think that that's something we've seen a lot from the RedHawks over this stretch of losing years that we've seen, is, you know, they can't not skate with any teams that are matched up against them on the ice. You know, we see them play with these teams and they're, you know, they're evenly matched night in, night out, but when you take 10 minutes off, and that goes all the way up and down the lineup, from not having any offensive shifts, from turning the puck over in the zone, from just, you know, not being able to pick up your guys, this league is too good and you're going to get pounced on. And the RedHawks got pounced on today, and they end up on the short end of things. And that's got to be a frustrating loss here for the RedHawks.
I agree. And it is, you got to play a full 60 minutes to be successful, especially in this league, and Miami failing to do that a lot of times this season, hence the results we've seen from the RedHawks so far in this year. So, Western Michigan now with a 4-8-3. Okay, I'm so confused because of the tie and the whole win thing with the shootout. So I believe Western Michigan's record is now 3-8-4. Miami's record is 4-8-3. So nobody gets a loss or a win. Technically, it's the tie. So Western Michigan 3-8-4, Miami 4-8-3. And that will give Miami still remains in seventh place in the NCHC standings, just 1 point in front of Western Michigan from their sweep last week. But still, it is a tough one for the RedHawks this weekend, only getting 1 point out of 6 in the NCHC standings. Want to thank you so much for listening to us here on RedHawk Radio this weekend. It is our final score today, a 3-3 tie, but 4-3 the lead for the win for Western Michigan today. So for Luke West Poley, Patrick Geshan, thank you so much for listening to us on RedHawk Radio today. Have a great rest of your evening as Miami and Western Michigan skate to the tie. Thanks for listening to this presentation of Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio.
Huskies come in on Friday, the 15th of January, to take on the RedHawks. The puck drops at 7 p.m.